special proudly brought to you by the all-new third-generation Toyota Prius. L'Oreal Paris Men Expert. The future of your skin is in your hands. You're worth it. Wii Sports Resort with Wii Motion Plus. Extra precise for extra fun. AAPT Unlimited Broadband 8 till 8. Sportsbet, Australia's number one betting agency. And for Australian-made and owned paracetamol, Simply Heron.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Brownlow Blue Carpet Arrivals. Well, tonight, it's probably the game's most important and certainly most glamorous of nights.
The stakes are high for the players, but for the girls, this is their grand final appearance, and we've got it covered from every angle. Box, and tonight with Brad Sewell, we're bringing you all the glamour and glitz from the Brownlow blue carpet.
And Fifi, looking absolutely sensational.
Well, thank you, Sewell. I can't take any of the credit. This creation is Bacchini and Hill, and my jewellery is by Cachette. And the ladies will agree, Sewell, you've scrubbed up quite a treat.
Flattery will get you nowhere. Now, tonight, we footballers are competitive beasts. I will be out there to get the best interviews for the night.
Oh, game on, Sewell. I'm taking you down. Cool. Let's go.
Nice to have some friendly competition early in the night. Hello, I'm Hamish McLaughlin and welcome to a very big night. Later on, we're going to find out who is the best and fairest player in the AFL competition. But right now, we're going to push the players aside and let the ladies shine. Speaking of which, a shining and stunning Rebecca Madden. Good evening.
Thank you very much, Hamish. It is such an exciting night this evening on this Brownlow blue carpet.
It is blue tonight. We're celebrating the launch of the new Toyota Prius. So blue is the new red.
Well, it's a pretty overwhelming experience for even the most seasoned performers on this Brownlow blue carpet this evening.
It is. There's been some early arrivals, so let's check now with Brad Sewell and Fifi Box on how they're going.
Hamish McIntosh and Chantelle Rayleigh, absolutely sensational tonight. And nice to see a little bit of the matching handkerchief there. Now, whose touch was that?
Oh, that was mine. We have to go matching.
Yeah. And it's been a busy day, has it?
Oh, not too bad.
Yeah, it's been a busy day for Chantelle. I've just been lazing around, mate, watching her get ready. So. Yeah.
And how did the spray tan go today?
Yeah, no spray tan for me, mate, but she hogged it all, so none left.
Now, Coxie, you've done very well tonight. Kerry, I have to say, one of the best on ground. You look absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
Did Dean have anything to do with this?
Yes, he did. He actually chose this on the net together.
You actually chose this on the net?
Yeah, so we obviously spotted one very similar and then went to our Kumi who made it, and they accommodated it very well and fitted it out to make sure that it fit perfectly.
Well, I'm incredibly impressed, and I have to say, Kerry, it's the first partner tonight who's actually in detail explained what a dress, how a dress is made, so I'm very impressed.
Oh, thank you.
Fev and Alex, once again, mate, you are taking a back seat. Alex looks sensational. Tell us about your dress.
It's a Holston dress and my jewellery's by Tomelli.
Yep. And recently launched a book. How's that going?
Going very well, thank you for asking. Yep. So you're selling well.
Guys, you are looking absolutely fabulous tonight. And I have to say, Dane, I think Taylor's upped your ink here because this dress is sensational. Taylor, you are wearing $500,000 worth of jewels.
That's very true. 1,105 10-point diamonds.
Absolutely stunning. You bought the dress in America, in the US, and brought it back?
No, I bought one and then I came back and the designer Aldo Terlato wanted me to wear this one and I said, how can you refuse?
It's just stunning. What does it feel like wearing that sort of cash around? Cash that we wouldn't earn in a lifetime.
Well, I guess you could say, to be cliche, it feels like $1,000,000.
And I know, Dane, you've actually been scrubbing up, doing a few, you know, man spas during the week.
Yeah, no, I've been doing heaps, yeah. It's been a big week for me, but it's all about the girls tonight, obviously, so I've just taken a back seat tonight.
I think 2009 might just set a new benchmark in terms of fashion. Some magnificent gowns walking the Brownlow blue carpet here tonight. Don't they look amazing?
Wow, well, haven't they set things alight? The girls have turned the Brownlow into the Gownlow for now. There's more colour and elegance when we return on the blue carpet arrivals.
Love to get to know you. Yeah.
by Brute Max. Performance antiperspirant. Brute, still brutally male. A&R, six stores, kicking with the best computers. The Advertiser, make the most of every game. KFC's Cane Grilled Chicken, more taste, more from KFC. And Unworry, with SGIC Insurance. I feel superhuman.
Of cameras, wonderful dresses, long legs, and plenty of colour so far on the blue carpet, including yourself, Beck, smoking hot, very pretty in pink.
Oh, thank you very much, Hamish. Yes, Helen Manuel from Manuel & Moore and I had a lot of fun designing this dress together. Jewellery by Anton, so I'm glad you like it.
Well, she has absolutely nailed it, but you're not the only Beck that has torn up the blue carpet.
No, Rebecca Twigley comes to mind. Now, as much as we adore her, she's got a lot to answer for because she single-handedly has really raised the bar in terms of dressing for this event.
Everybody remembers that red dress, an absolute corker. We're going to take a walk down Australian red carpet memory lane and join Sonia Kruger for the hits and misses.
Well, the Brownlow has had a history of making fashion statements that have had the whole world talking.
Of course, the biggest show stealer of all was Rebecca Twigley's best on carpet performance in 2004.
I think Rebecca Twigley's red dress started this whole less is more attitude to this wag dressing.
Didn't know you before, know you now.
How about that? It was amazing.
Lots of other wives and girlfriends have caught the umpire's eyes.
I designed that one for Tanya 9 years ago. Let it go, guys.
Shane Warne, 23. Dermy Bruton, 23. Michael Jordan, 23. Buddy, 23. Rachel McLeod, 23.
Seasoned wags like to go for the elegant and demure look.
These girls always seem to get it right. The key is that they keep it simple and elegant.
Others choose to reveal acres of flesh.
For the young ladies out there that want to make a name for themselves, less is best.
And next year you'll see someone just wearing a G-string or a bikini.
Over the years, the blokes have worn some Barry Crockers.
James Heard, oh, shocking.
But honestly, who cares what the players wear so long as they understand that on Brownlow night, they play second fiddle.
For us blokes, 15 minutes preparation, no more.
Australian sport and fashion have always been lively bedmates.
I wouldn't like my wife showing her knickers like that.
Old codgers at the Melbourne Cup still break out in a sweat when they recall Gene Shrimpton's appearance 44 years ago.
Good on you, Gene. Great vision. Great vision.
But for carpet gazers, this is footy's night of nights. Your time as fans to sit back and drink it all in.
Well, it's the night of nights for the girls. Who cares who wins the medal?
Even if you don't know a drop kick from a drop punt, tonight you get to award the votes. You get to decide who is best and fairest and who takes home the fashion medal.
Yes, there will be a chance for you to vote later on in the evening. Now, less is best. I'm not quite sure if I agree with the Ox on that one.
Oh, I'm sort of with the Ox.
Oh, how did I know you were going to say that? Well, no doubt many of the gowns you'll be seeing this evening will be remembered in years to come. Let's see who's stealing the show this year.
Chris Judd, Rebecca Twigley, glamour couple once again. We'll get straight into it. Rebecca, is Chris a chance to propose anytime soon?
I don't think so.
What's he waiting for?
I don't know.
And tell us what you're wearing. Looking sensational.
Thank you, Jeton Couture. Yep. And all accessories from Maya and Paul Bram Diamonds. So
sensational.
Put all the plugs in.
Oh, look at this. The posh and becks of the Western Bulldogs. Looking fantastic tonight. Helen, can I just see any burger ring accessories? Oh, look at that. Coons, you've come the goods there.
Certainly upgraded on the burger ring, haven't we?
Haven't you? You certainly have. And I thought you might have the medal around your neck tonight. Where is it?
No, I've got it in my pocket. I'm going to save it for later.
Okay. Yeah. And I've got to say, Hayley, is Adam the sort of guy who stands at the door with jangling the keys going, can you hurry up and get ready?
Hurry up. It takes him about, 4 minutes?
Yeah, it took me a good 4.5 minutes to get ready tonight. So.
Definitely.
And it's so very supportive. And did he have anything to do with his outfit? Because it is absolutely beautiful.
Thank you very much. Nothing to do with the outfit. Good. Nothing at all.
Jimmy, Nadia, it is true, mate. The nice guys do get the good-looking girls.
Yeah, I think I'm batting above my average here. Fluke this one.
I absolutely agree. Tell us about your dress, Nadia.
Thank you. It's Manulin Moore and jewellery by Anton.
Yep, lovely. And you're looking forward to the week ahead again?
Yeah, can't wait. Any chance to play in a grand final, you know, every player wants to be there.
Here with a man that's fresh off starring in the latest beer commercials of men punching above their weight, Andrew Demetriou, with drop-dead gorgeous wife Simone. Andrew, you kicked off the voting last year in round 2. Where do you think you'll kick it off tonight?
Probably round 22, the way things are going.
Work backwards?
I hope so.
And Simone, you're the first lady of football. Any extra pressure on the blue carpet?
No, not at all, no.
Who have you gone with tonight, designer-wise?
Scanlan and Theodore.
And you're pregnant, due in November. He's the master of the pregnant pauses. Have you given him a hand? Has he been practicing anything at home?
He's just been practicing counting from 1 to 2, really. Get the rounds in order this year.
And he's been, he's going to be on stage a lot tonight. If you could have dinner in his absence with anyone in the world, who would it be?
Probably Johnny Depp, Robbie Williams.
Oh, thanks very much, darling.
Nice options. The Demetrios, 3 votes to them. They're both looking al dente. Back to you, Beck.
Some of the most beautiful women in Australia walking the Brownlow blue carpet here tonight. Gee whiz, don't those AFL boys do well for themselves. A very important night too for the designers who have been working tirelessly to bring you these magnificent gowns. Now, don't go anywhere. We'll be back with more of the Brownlow blue carpet right after this.
Carpet Special, proudly brought to you by the all-new third-generation Toyota Prius.
Boshy, how are you, mate?
Good, mate. How you doing? Ready for this?
I'm not too sure. Yeah. Here we go.
Hi, guys.
Hey. Thank you.
Thank you.
For a big day pampering today.
Excellent.
We'll go upstairs.
That's okay. You guys look amazing.
What do you reckon, Welshie?
Yeah, not bad. Pretty happy with the back part.
Yeah, thank you very much for that. No worries, thank you. See you later. Beautiful. Sammy, can we get that kit up, mate?
Oh, beautiful. Yeah, I'll just get it for you. I've got it at the back.
Alright, boys, smile a little bit better in this.
Really, mate, what's happening
there, mate?
Got your speech ready for it, all right?
Very handsome.
Very good.
Very good.
Good job, mate. Thank you. I'm going to get it off for you, guys. Thanks, mate. No worries. Thanks, man. Thanks, guys.
D. Swan, 3 votes. Swan will kick the goal. Possibly the hottest couple on the blue carpet tonight, Luke Hodge and Lauren Kirkman. Hodgie, facials, massages, and apparently a solarium. Any truth?
No, that's not true. Brad Sewell just bought into a solarium, so that's why he was trying to get out there.
Now, Lauren, childhood sweethearts, you two. Who pursued who?
Luke definitely did all the pursuing.
Ah, Hodgie. Now, you look amazing tonight. Anything you fear on the blue carpet?
Well, I think my designer's done a good job tonight. So, Helen at Manual and Moore, and Luke looks great in the Soho workshop suit.
I can't leave you without a tip, Hodgie. Who do you think wins tonight?
Swanee, I reckon.
Lauren?
I might go Gary.
Little Gary. Mm. The Hodges looking immaculate. Back to you, Beck.
Luke and Lauren, definitely one of the it couples here this evening. Now, speaking of people in the spotlight, one man who's used to being in it on a night like this is a former winner of the prestigious medal. And, of course, I speak of Nathan Buckley. Now, he's with his partner in crime from that same year, Mark Prosciutto.
Thanks, Beck. We're here at JJ's and a few of the past winners are mingling around the bar having a chat. I'm here with Mark Prosciutto. And, Roo, who do you reckon is going to take the Charlie home tonight?
I think it's going to be a big week for Geelong Bucks. I think Gary Ablett will win tonight, and I think he'll win on Saturday. So he's going to be very hard to beat. I think Nick Riewoldt will go well. He's the best forward in the competition. But I think our old mate Adam Goods might be a bit of a smoky as well and might win his third.
And what about the Adelaide Crows? Anyone from there going to poll heavily?
I think Bernie Vince might be a real outsider. He's got the good looks and the blonde hair, which the umpires love, so maybe he might be a smoky at 30s.
I'll let you head back to the bar, mate. Make sure you're watching tonight, Channel 7, the Brownlow Medal.
Well, it's easy to forget amongst all this sex and sizzle that there's actually a vote count going on tonight to decide the AFL's best and fairest. So with all the latest odds from sportsbet.com.au, Matty Tripp.
As the countdown continues, here are the market leaders for tonight's coveted prize. All the late money has been for Gary Ablett and he is now the clear top pick. One-time favourite Dane Swan holds down second place at Good Each Way Value ahead of two-time winner Adam Goods and another proven vote winner in Chris Judd. Nick Del Santo heads a host of St Kilda midfielders who together with Nick Riewoldt should dominate polling between them. Sportsbet.com.au will be betting live throughout the evening. For up-to-date odds, simply phone 1800 138 238.
Oh, odds, betting and tipping, whatever. We'll be back with more of the important stuff, the fashion, right after this.
Performance antiperspirant. Brute, still brutally male. A&R, six stores, kicking with the best computers. The Advertiser, make the most of every game. KFC's Cane Grilled Chicken, more taste, more from KFC. And Unworry, with SGIC Insurance.
It's ridiculous.
You got your favourite yet, Hamish?
I reckon I'm down to my top 15.
Just 15.
Well, let's see if we can't add a few more to that list.
And here we are with one of the most famous Brownlow names in recent years, Lauren Phillips. Who have you bought tonight?
I brought Gary Ablett with me tonight, and he's lucky to get a gig the way he's going tonight. We're so late.
Sensational. And you've got the invites, of course. You'll need them to get in.
No, we haven't actually. We forgot them. So we're hoping we can sneak through.
I've got a feeling you might be right. Now, are you looking forward to the end of the year? Good chance to get away and spend some quality time together?
Oh, well, ask Gary what he's doing at the end of the season.
I've planned a couple of trips away with the boys, and Lauren wasn't very happy about that, but I'm sure we'll squeeze some time.
He's got three footy trips, and I'm cool with that.
And you don't get a guaranteed one of them?
No.
Oh, mate, very understanding. Now, tell us about what you're wearing tonight, Lauren.
I'm wearing Furley. Helen O'Connor has designed my dress for the third year in a row, so I think when you're on a good thing, you should stick to it.
Yep.
And Jan Logan has done my jewels tonight, so I'm a very lucky girl.
And Tom, I mean, do you, when you're preparing for the day, any manscaping, any grooming that's gone into this, I can see that you haven't actually got out the razor.
No, hair and face cop the same treatment, and that was a quick once over on the number one comb, and that was a bit of, I used the moisturiser, so
nice.
Yeah, no, I feel good.
And are you more nervous about this Saturday or the big day in a couple of weeks?
I think I'll just tick them off as they come.
Yeah, exactly. Priorities split. Good thinking. Yeah.
Now, Joey, you're a bit of a rooster. You spent most of the day manscaping, I'm sure.
No, I didn't actually, Brad. We had training today and I went and got a quick trim, but that was about it for me.
Very sharp too. Yeah. And looking sensational. Tell us about your dress tonight.
Thank you. This dress is made by Connie Simonetti.
Yep.
She's based in High Street in Armidale, which is a very talented woman.
Were you able to get in front of the mirror at all, or do you sort of take most of the time up there?
I was like, Lee, let me have it.
I could just imagine. Yeah. I hope you both have a great night and good luck for the week.
Yeah, thanks, mate. Thank you.
Cuz, Dave, looking spectacular tonight. Yeah. I am surprised, Steve, you did ring me to check what I was wearing.
Yes.
You didn't think to ring Dave, perhaps, to ask what he was wearing?
No, I didn't. When I found out you weren't wearing velour, I thought, good to go, and imagine velour. My surprise.
This is not velour, it's a cotton. It's a cotton blend.
Who are you dressed by, Dave?
Well, this is made from... It's Hang on. Let's it's very, you should check.
Look at this. It's quite a slimming jacket, this. And out he comes.
Look at that, Dave. Fantastic.
Oh, Hamish, you have been drooling for the past half an hour.
I'm not going to lie to you. I've almost dehydrated through a loss of saliva because the most beautiful women in Australia are here tonight.
Well, I know you won't be able to narrow it down to just one, but you can do that at home thanks to Toyota Prius.
Choose who you think is the best dressed at this year's Brownlow Medal to be in with a chance to win the best dressed AFL experience. Thanks to Toyota's third generation Prius, you could be the one to toss the coin in front of a packed MCG crowd at the 2009 Toyota AFL Grand Final. Select your favourite and call or SMS A, B or C along with your full name and state to be in the running. To find out if you've won, be watching Season's Best this Wednesday on 7.
So not too many surprises there. Rebecca Twigley, Tanya Hurd and Felicity Percival. Who gets the votes, please, Ben?
Oh, I'm a little bit biased, Geelong. I'd have to say Felicity Percival. She looked beautiful.
Well, I'm giving you two votes tonight, Julie. Well done and thank you.
Thanks very much. I had a great time.
And Fifi, you get all three.
Oh, thank you, hey. Appreciate that. Sorry, Sully.
Pleasure. Hope you enjoyed the blue carpet arrival. Stay with us on 7 because the real vote, it's just about to get underway. Hope you can join us. Good night.
Good night, everyone.
...100 kilowatt Toyota Orion V6. L'Oreal Paris Men Expert. The future of your skin is in your hands. You're worth it. We Sports Resort with We Motion Plus. Extra precise for extra fun. AAPT Unlimited Broadband 8 till 8. Sportsbet, Australia's number one betting agency. And for Australian made and own paracetamol, Simply Heron.
Edmonds picks up the ball. Blind turns, dances around his opponent, shimmies, takes a bounce. Oh, that's ambitious. Snaps from the impossible angle. Can he do it? Of course he can! Nick Hart, everybody! Mitchell Edmonds, he's got my three votes.
Mitchell!
No, Mum, we're in time on.
It's time off. You need an early night.
But the Brownlow's on.
But nothing. It's bath and bed for you, mate.
Night, mate.
No.
Great dreams.
It's another thriller on Friday Night Footy.
Wow, Mitch Edmonds pulls in a screamer.
It's like a rampant weedies everywhere.
Edmonds pounces, gathers, snaps. Can he do it? Of course he can.
It's another best on ground performance. Mitch Edmonds has to be a huge chance for the Brownlow.
Dennis.
Round 22. St Kilda. Al Montagna. One vote. St Kilda. N. Del Santo. Two votes.
Now, if Edmonds gets three votes here, he'll win the Brownlow Medal.
Ringwood Secondary College. N. Edmonds. Three votes.
And here to present the medal is the reigning Brownlow medalist, Adam Cooney.
Congratulations, Mitch.
Well done, mate.
Hello, everybody. That was only a dream, but this medal is real. Tonight, someone's boyhood dream will come true. I'd just like to say to all you mums out there, please don't send your kids to bed until we know who's won this medal. Come on, mums. It's the Brownlow. We love it.
Do you mind?
Oh. Swan kicks to work.
stadium a crown. Welcome to the 2009 Brownlow Medal Count, brought to you by Toyota. Now, please welcome your host, Sandy Roberts.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, good evening, and what a night it is going to be. And what an opening that was. I just wonder, you know, in some 10 years' time, we'll be reading out the name Mitch Edmonds. I think we should show our appreciation once again for Mitch and say well done and good luck. But he did ask the question, who will achieve his boyhood dream tonight? Will it be Gary Ablett, hoping to add to a family trophy cabinet that already contains a premiership, a Norm Smith medal and three Coleman medals? Or will it be Dane Swan, striving to join an honour roll of Collingwood Brownlow medalists that boast names like Coventry, Collier, Thompson and Buckley? Or Chris Judd? If he wins, he'll be only the fourth player to win the Brownlow for different clubs. And Adam Goods, what a vote-getter this star from Sydney is. The only player who's polled at least 20 Brownlow votes in three consecutive seasons. Wins tonight and he'll join the Immortals. Only the fifth player in history to win three Brownlow medals. And then, of course, there are the Saints. What a season. And they have five of the 12 favourites here tonight. Brendan Goddard, Lee Montagna, Nick Del Santo, Lenny Hayes, and, of course, their inspirational captain, Nick Riewoldt. All would be very worthy Brownlow winners. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, would you please make welcome the AFL's Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Andrew Demetriou.
Good evening, and welcome tonight to the 82nd Brownlow Medal Count. Tonight's gathering is a properly constituted meeting of the AFL with all commissioners present, except for Bob Hammond, who cannot be here with us tonight. The first order of business was a resolution that this year I read the votes in order from round one and not round two. That was passed unanimously. Joining me on my table to supervise the count and ensure the votes are read in the right order, the AFL's General Manager of Football Operations, Adrian Anderson, Football Projects Manager, Dean Moore, our Ground Operations Manager, Jill Lindsay, and Football Administration Manager, Rod Austin. In accordance with AFL Regulation 17, at the conclusion of each match, the three field umpires conferred and recorded their opinion of the three fairest and best players in each of the 176 home and away matches played this season. The votes were then placed in a sealed envelope marked Brownlow Medal. In the case of two or more players receiving an equal number of votes, each shall be declared the joint winner and each of these players shall be awarded a Brownlow Medal. If a player has been found guilty of a reportable offence in a home and away match in which the Brownlow Medal votes have been cast, the player shall remain eligible to win the Brownlow Medal if the sanction for the reportable offence is a financial sanction only, or the base demerit points allocated to that reportable offence are less than 100 points. This night is one of our special nights, and I want to again welcome everyone here and at home and thank all the players, officials and supporters who have made the 2009 Toyota AFL season such a wonderful success. Thank you.
Andrew, just before I let you go, if we go back to the start of the season, do you think you could have scripted a better finish to the year?
Sandy, it's been a great year. It's been absolutely superb, and the two best teams have got through. They've been superb all year, and if we can get a repeat of round 14 this week, we'll be absolutely delighted.
Good luck with the count.
Thank you, Sandy.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you the votes for this year's count have been delivered to Palladium by our Armour Guard friends. It's the contents of these safe boxes which hold the key, of course, for tonight's proceedings. And so we start by turning the clock back some 6 months to round one. And it was a former Brownlow medalist who was all the rage in the lead-up to the season opener.
The build-up was all about Cousins.
And it took Cousins 12 seconds to gain his first possession.
86,000 saw Ben come back with a bang, but end the night with a twang.
Oh, he's gone, boys. He's in trouble.
Yep, it looked like another long year for the Tigers.
Hope he wasn't pondering jumping.
As the Blues got off to a flyer.
Oh, what a great
Saints fans hadn't forgotten their hero. But life without halves began with a high.
Oh, that's a great crack.
The Pies down by 4 points to Adelaide. But don't ask the coach what they came to play.
What do they bring? They come to play marbles?
Darren Jolly tried to jump his way into the Mile High Club. For Shannon Hearn, it was the Mile Long Club.
He kicks it. A mile. An absolute mile.
And Geelong at last got one over Hawthorn.
Well, that's the way they would a hawk.
Ablett started the season with a blind.
Go, it's a goal.
Round one, the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Richmond versus Carlton. Carlton, M. Murphy, 1 vote. Carlton, E. Betts, 2 votes. Carlton, B. Gibbs, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Geelong. Geelong, B. Ottens, 1 vote. Hawthorn, S. Mitchell, 2 votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Adelaide. Collingwood, D. Swan, 1 vote. Adelaide, T. Edwards, 2 votes. Adelaide, B. Vince, 3 votes. Brisbane versus West Coast. West Coast, M. Lacroix, 1 vote. Brisbane, T. Johnston, 2 votes. Brisbane, L. Power, 3 votes. St. Kilda versus Sydney. St. Kilda, S. Gilbert, 1 vote. St. Kilda, J. Kaczynski, 2 votes. St. Kilda, B. Goddard, 3 votes. Melbourne versus North Melbourne. Melbourne, N. Jones, 1 vote. North Melbourne, L. Harding, 2 votes. North Melbourne, H. McIntosh, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Essendon. Port Adelaide, D. Motlop, 1 vote. Essendon, A. Lovett, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, B. Ebert, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, M. Hahn, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, S. Higgins, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, M. Boyd, 3 votes.
Thank you, Andrew. So we are away and running. And throughout the night, our football experts, namely Nathan Buckley and Lee Matthews, will be looking at a number of the favourites for tonight's medal. The first of our Orion contenders is one of the stars from Moorabbin.
Johnny the Wind, Del Santo, the steal. Has it got the carry? It has.
I think the highlight of Nick Del Santo is his efficiency by foot. He virtually finds a target every time he gets a little bit of time and space.
Del Santo slips the tackle, runs around and kicks the goal.
Nick Del Santo's been touted as a Brownlow medal contender. Yeah, since his first game. He's just got that type of game style that lends itself. It's flashy, he's consistent, but he's also very efficient with the footy.
Antiperspirants, brute, still brutally male. A&R, six stores kicking with the best computers. The Advertiser, make the most of every game. KFC's canned grilled chicken, more taste, more from KFC. Sip and save, open late, no dramas. And Unworry with SGIC Insurance.
Footy attracts all types these days, from passionate presidents to spin kings, even top guns. There were supermodels too, but with fashion anything went, tutus and G-strings included. As always, Magpie fans had their unique style. And there was something familiar about the way the Tigers looked.
Hope he wasn't pondering jumping.
At St Kilda they danced, and they sang terribly. But at least we know they didn't have to mime.
Against the famous Bulldogs.
At Geelong they were bang on target with their long-range missiles. However, not every rocket was firing.
She's bored to death.
But whether you were after a peck or a proposal, the footy was the place to get lucky. Yep. Lucky pretty much covers this fella's night. Just a shame about the view of the game.
Yes, as we see at the footy, the crowd does react in all manner of ways. To the action now on the field, let's move to the second round, and Hawthorn's bumpy season looks set to continue.
High one, good, oh, what a leap!
The Swans got the jump on the Hawks as the reigning premiers took another hit. Cozzie too was off target, but the Saints won in Adelaide. And there was nothing wrong with Alwyn Davies' radar.
And that is a work of art.
The swagger was well and truly back at Carlton.
Some party tricks.
As their second win put the Blues on top.
It's a miracle worker.
Daniel Kerr was back to his blistering best.
The excitement machine got around Chaplin. Launches from 50.
A 70-metre goal capping off a 50-point win for the Eagles.
Lynch with a ripping goal.
And the Dogs went 2-0, doing it with their eyes closed.
Hard to play like that. A hooded bulldog.
Round two of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Adelaide versus St Kilda. Adelaide, Jay Paul Pleasure, one vote. St Kilda, Jay Kaczynski, two votes. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, three votes. Geelong versus Richmond. Geelong, S. Johnson, one vote. Geelong, G. Ablett, two votes. Richmond, M. Richardson, three votes. Collingwood versus Melbourne. Melbourne, A. Davey, one vote. Collingwood, A. Didak, two votes. Collingwood, J. Fraser, three votes. Carlton versus Brisbane. Carlton, R. Hadley, one vote. Carlton, B. Gibbs, two votes. Carlton, M. Murphy, three votes. Sydney versus Hawthorn. Sydney, D. Jolly, one vote. Sydney, J. McVeigh, two votes. Sydney, C. Bolton, three votes. Essendon versus Fremantle. Essendon, A. Lovett, one vote. Essendon, J. Winderlick, two votes. Essendon, D. Fletcher, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus North Melbourne. Western Bulldogs, R. Griffin, one vote. North Melbourne, A. Simpson, two votes. Western Bulldogs, B. Lake, three votes. West Coast Eagles versus Port Adelaide. West Coast, D. Cox, one vote. West Coast, S. Hearn, two votes. West Coast, D. Kerr, three votes.
Thank you, Andrew. It's interesting to see Richo in the votes once again. That is for the 17th consecutive season that he has polled here at the Brownlow. An amazing feat. And we look forward to him lining up again next season at Punroad. But right now, let us join Tim Watson, who is with the Saints skipper, Nick Riewoldt. Tim?
Well, Nick, welcome. They say that you try and keep this week as normal as possible, but it's anything but a normal week.
Yeah, it's not, but it's a position that we want to be in and have been striving to be in all year. So we'll prepare ourselves as best we can and look forward to the weekend.
How do you relax during the week?
I think just try to do everything as normally as possible. We've still got training and football commitments to fulfil, so do those to the best of your ability and just enjoy the rest of the experience.
A lot of talent at this table. Is there a Brownlow medalist amongst them?
Oh, potentially, yeah, for sure. I think BJ and Dell have both got off to good starts there. Joey's a little bit disappointed, but he'll poll well later on, I'm sure.
Good luck at the weekend, Nick.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah, thank you, Tim, and good luck to the Saints and the Cats this coming Saturday. As we head into round three, it was another of the game's great forwards who this time made a huge impact.
Easter and Matthew Lloyd showed his critics that he was far from dead and buried.
It's a classic mark from Matthew Lloyd.
Fev had a new trick.
Isn't that a coordination trick?
But it was the Bombers celebrating with a win over the Blues in a thriller. The Hawks were back in the winner's circle, and the Saints showed they meant business with a 97-point thrashing of the Eagles. Heath Shaw copped a week for touching an umpire on the arm. But hitting him in the head was another thing.
Rebound straight onto the goal umpire's noggin, and she's happy.
The Wizard of Port waved his wand.
He's always got to do that.
And the power flexed their muscles over the demons.
He's going to go on the limit.
Round three. Geelong versus Collingwood. Geelong, G. Ablett, one vote. Geelong, S. Johnson, two votes. Geelong, P. Chapman, three votes. St Kilda versus West Coast. St Kilda, J. Kaczynski, one vote. St Kilda, M. Gardner, two votes. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, three votes. Brisbane versus Sydney. Brisbane, J. Drummond, one vote. Brisbane, J. Brown, two votes. Brisbane, J. Patful, three votes. Carlton versus Essendon. Essendon, M. Lloyd, one vote. Essendon, B. Stanton, two votes. Carlton, C. Judd, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Melbourne. Port Adelaide, D. Pierce, one vote. Port Adelaide, D. Motlop, two votes. Port Adelaide, W. Tredray, three votes. North Melbourne versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, C. Rioli, one vote. Hawthorn, J. Roughhead, two votes. Hawthorn, S. Mitchell, three votes. Fremantle versus Adelaide. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 1 vote. Adelaide, K. Tippett, 2 votes. Adelaide, R. Douglas, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Richmond. Western Bulldogs, D. Addison, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, L. Gilby, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, J. Akermanis, 3 votes.
Only 3 rounds gone, but already plenty of excitement with Gary Ablett and Nick Dal Santo. We know they had fantastic starts of the season, and it is showing at this very early stage in the Brownlow count.
Well, what a night it's been so far, Haim. All the glitz and the glamour. Don't forget to miss it tomorrow morning on Sunrise, and a big night on Seven on Wednesday night, Haim.
Yeah, big night. Little Gazza, who's leading the count, he joins us. Barry Hall, Jason Akermanis and Nathan Buckley. Probably for the last time, being honest. 9:30 on Wednesday. We hope you can join us. Season's best.
I've got to look for mine. It's in the indoor.
Walk-in robe or something, isn't it?
You're a disgrace, Gouchy.
You're a disgrace.
No.
You picked it by 2 votes. I was runner-up in 89.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's probably a good place. Why don't you give it to me then?
You don't know where your Brownlow is?
No, I have no idea. I'm serious. But then there's Ian Stewart, of course, who doesn't know where any of his three are.
Jimmy Steins, where's your Brownlow?
Well, my wife was asking me the same question a couple of weeks ago, and I wasn't too sure. I think I know where it is, but I've been a little bit busy, a little bit preoccupied.
Come on, Jim, no one believes you. You know where your Brownlow medal is.
No, I think it's in the study, but we renovated the house last year, so a few things have been mislaid along the way, I think.
You won the Brownlow back in 91. What do you remember about that night?
Oh, look, it was just the most amazing night, really. You know, I had my dad there, which was very, very special, and the family. And, you know, just have all your teammates and, you know, just to do something very, very different. Never expected it. And you know, here we come every year and we get to experience someone new, get up there and have an amazing experience like I did.
The Demons haven't had a great year in terms of wins and losses. I mean, wins. They haven't had a great year. They've had a few losses. What, in terms of their development, you must be pleased with the way they're going and the direction they're headed, though.
Yeah, look, I'm really proud of the club, the way, you know, because we've had to weather a huge storm. But I think, you know, we're now coming out of it, and obviously the draft helps. But the boys have really stuck to their guns, and it's been tough for them. But, you know, I just keep seeing kids growing and becoming more competitive, and that's really what we wanted this year, and they've done themselves proud.
Great to see you here tonight. Good luck.
Thank you, and it's great to be here. Thank you. Thank you.
Indeed it is, yes. Wonderful to see you here tonight. Good luck to Jim and the Demons in the months and years ahead. Well, the Brownlow isn't the Brownlow without the umpires. And in round 4, it was all about them.
It was umpire recognition round.
What happened there?
He's bleeding black. And umpire Scott McLaren gave us something to recognise.
Beautiful ball skills.
Although not everyone was so admiring of the whistleblower's skills. It was a tough week for the coaching fraternity. But as they got a little greyer and thinner on top, Gazza had a new do. And with it, a record-breaking 46 possessions to celebrate his 150th in style.
That is magical.
Incredible.
What a start.
Tom Logan discovered a new way to tag Luke Hodge.
At the back, Logan's got the set and takes a screamer.
As the power consigned the Hawks to a 1-3 start to the year.
OK, I'll lead off the bat. Clearly we're not good enough.
An 83-point loss to St Kilda kept Mark Harvey's Fremantle winless, and the news didn't get any better for Terry Wallace and the Tigers.
What a win, and at the same time, what a loss.
The Demons' heart was once again beating true as President Jimmy made his mark on Melbourne.
How about that? Jimmy Steins, that's a contested mark too.
Round 4 of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Brisbane versus Collingwood. Collingwood, P. Medhurst, 1 vote. Brisbane, B. Dalziel, 2 votes. Collingwood, S. Pendlebury, 3 votes. Sydney versus Carlton. Sydney, R. Shaw, 1 vote. Sydney, C. Bolton, 2 votes. Sydney, J. McVeigh, 3 votes. Hawthorne versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, T. Boak, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, 3 votes. St Kilda versus Fremantle. St Kilda, N. Revolt, 1 vote. St Kilda, L. Montagna, 2 votes. St Kilda and Del Santo, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Geelong. Geelong, J. Corey, 1 vote. Geelong, J. Bartell, 2 votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Essendon. Essendon, A. Davey, 1 vote. North Melbourne, D. Hale, 2 votes. North Melbourne, B. Harvey, 3 votes. Richmond versus Melbourne. Melbourne, B. McLean, 1 vote. Richmond, A. Davey, 2 votes. Melbourne, A. Davey, 2 votes. Richmond, M. Richardson, 3 votes. West Coast versus Western Bulldogs. West Coast, D. Wirrupunda, 1 vote. West Coast, D. Cox, 2 votes. West Coast, D. Kerr, 3 votes.
Last post!
It was another Anzac Day to remember.
There's Hill.
Oh, he's hurt himself. I think he's twisted the knee.
With the Bombers down early, Paddy Ryder rucked his way to an Anzac medal, while David Zaharakis lived out every boy's dream.
Zaharakis has kicked a goal! The Bombers are in front of the G!
Stephen Milne had the ball on a string.
That is magnificent!
While Brett Jones had it on his head.
Off his head!
Ablett moved to odds-on Brownlow favour with 42 disposals and another miracle from the pocket.
That is as good as it gets from the genius.
The Dockers got off the canvas for their first win of the season and the spirits were up in Tigerland as they celebrated the triumphant return of old favourite Mark Coghlan.
Have you ever seen scenes like that?
Round 5, Port Adelaide versus St Kilda. St Kilda, C. Jones, 1 vote. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 2 votes. St Kilda, L. Hayes, 3 votes. Essendon versus Collingwood. Collingwood, D. Swan, 1 vote. Essendon, A. Lovett, 2 votes. Essendon, P. Ryder, 3 votes. Hawthorne versus West Coast. Hawthorne, L. Hodge, 1 vote. Hawthorne, S. Mitchell, 2 votes. Hawthorne, B. Sewell, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Sydney. Fremantle, L. McFarlane, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, 2 votes. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Richmond. North Melbourne, A. Swallow, 1 vote. Richmond, B. Deledio, 2 votes. Richmond, D. Jackson, 3 votes. Geelong versus Brisbane. Geelong, P. Chapman, 1 vote. Geelong, C. Mooney, 2 votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Carlton. Carlton, B. Gibbs, 1 vote. Carlton, B. Thornton, 2 votes. Carlton, M. Murphy, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Adelaide. Adelaide, B. Vince, 1 vote. Adelaide, B. Rutten, 2 votes. Adelaide, S. Goodwin, 3 votes.
So a couple of early flyers as we check the Orion leaderboard for the first time. And Gary Ablett showing the way with 12 votes. In fact, the last time someone had scored 12 votes after 5 rounds was back in 1987. It was Paul Molly Meldrum of Carlton. Ablett on 12, Nick Del Santo just 1 behind on 11. Mark Murphy is on 7 and Sam Mitchell of Hawthorne is also on 7. Bryce Gibbs has started well, so too has Richo with 6 votes. Daniel Kerr has 6 and Sydney's Craig Bolton is on 5. As we go to the break, we're going to check in again with Lee Matthews and also Nathan Buckley and our next Orion contender, none other than Gary Ablett.
The magician, can he start well? Oh, you betcha!
Gary Ablett almost won the medal last year. He's carried on with his form and his work rate is probably as high as anyone in the competition, both running with the ball and defending.
From the pocket, that is as good as it gets.
I think one of the great things about Gary is when he gets the ball centre or forward, he can either set up his teammates, really efficient by foot or hand, but he can get through the 50-metre line and kick the goals himself.
Rob Ablett, well, he's on again, runs inside the 50, kicks a goal.
Well, it's that time of the year where everybody in football is just thinking one thing. What's the halftime entertainment going to be on grand final day? Let's go and ask the experts.
Black Eyed Peas. Yep. Boom, boom, pow. Boom, yep. Boom, pow. Boom, boom, pow. I got a feeling that tonight's going to be a good night.
Good night.
And tonight's going to be a good night.
Good night.
AC/DC.
AC/DC. Now, that's my man.
Michael Jackson.
Bring him back from the dead, I say. Michael Jackson, halftime entertainment. Fergalicious?
Yeah.
She'd be all right at halftime too, wouldn't she?
Gotta get if you say so. Be that. I can't really know the words, but I like this song and the beat.
Now, you may be wondering who that last little fella was. Well, some fancy footwork there from one Zach Knights. Reminiscent of his dad, Essendon coach Matthew Knights. And Matty, well done on taking the Bombers into the finals for the first time in 5 years, and good luck in the future. Also, ladies and gentlemen, throughout the night, we're going to be putting up a little mini leaderboard that you will see on your screens so you can keep up to date with our top five or six players in this year's Brownlow medal. Bear in mind, a cross next to a player's name rules that player ineligible as we head to round six, and a big weekend for some of the game's best forwards.
A milestone match for the Bombers.
Matthew Lloyd becomes the eighth player in football history to kick 900 goals.
But it was the Lions flying highest.
Brennan over the top takes a hanger.
A sweet night for Coach Voss, but a sour 300 for a broken leg of Dustin Fletcher. One dodgy groin suspended Brownlow betting, and one gammy hammy brought the running man to a halt. Showdown bragging rights went to Port, and Pav celebrated his 200th as a derby winner. A change of strip and game plan at the Roos,
Gabriella Banastuta,
couldn't bring the Pies down. There was a lot to love about the Fev and Ruffy show at the G.
Ruffy!
8 goals each, and the one that got away.
Round six of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. North Melbourne versus Collingwood. Collingwood, S. Pendlebury, 1 vote. Collingwood, L. Davis, 2 votes. Collingwood, T. Lockyer, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Carlton. Carlton, C. Judd, 1 vote. Hawthorn, J. Roughhead, 2 votes. Hawthorn, B. Sewell, 3 votes. West Coast versus Fremantle. West Coast, S. Hearn, 1 vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 2 votes. Fremantle, S. Hill, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Essendon. Brisbane, T. Johnston, 1 vote. Brisbane, Al Power, 2 votes. Brisbane, J. Brown, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Adelaide. Port Adelaide, J. Surgeon, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, D. Brogan, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, D. Pierce, 3 votes. Sydney versus Richmond. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, 1 vote. Sydney, R. Shaw, 2 votes. Sydney, M. Matner, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Geelong. Geelong, S. Johnson, 1 vote. Geelong, J. Bartell, 2 votes. Geelong, P. Chapman, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus St. Kilda. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, 1 vote. St. Kilda, F. Ray, 2 votes. St. Kilda, B. Goddard, 3 votes.
Glorious victory to the Bombers.
The Bomber Brigade had plenty to sing about as their boys flew up. A 44-point loss for the Hawks, and the reigning premiers were out of the eight. It was another bloody day for the Tigers. Not that Alex Rance will remember too much of it. Sick and sorry, Troy Selwood walked away. Yep, nothing a few pats on the head from his teammates won't fix.
North Melbourne with a thriller!
It was the Roos over Port in a thriller, and the Dockers made it 3 straight on the Gold Coast.
It's their best for a long time.
No Ablett. No problem for Geelong. Steve Johnson taking over as top cat.
He is amazing!
It's Monday Night Football.
And a new time slot proved a big winner with St Kilda. 88-point winners. Yep, just ask Stephen Milne how good the Saints were. Believe it or not, the Barrackers didn't agree.
Round 7, Essendon versus Hawthorn. Essendon, M. Lloyd, 1 vote. Essendon, J. Windelick, 2 votes. Essendon, B. Stanton, 3 votes. Geelong versus Sydney. Geelong, J. Selwood, 1 vote. Geelong, J. Corey, 2 votes. Sydney, A. Goods, 3 votes. Richmond versus Brisbane. Richmond, N. Foley, 1 vote. Brisbane, D. Merritt, 2 votes. Brisbane, J. Brown, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Port Adelaide. North Melbourne, A. Swallow, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, K. Corns, 2 votes. North Melbourne, A. Simpson, 3 votes. Carlton versus Fremantle. Fremantle, L. McFarlane, 1 vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 2 votes. Fremantle, A. Sandilands, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, J. Hill, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, N. Eagleton, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, D. Cross, 3 votes. West Coast versus Melbourne. West Coast, A. Selwood, 1 vote. Melbourne, N. Jones, 2 votes. West Coast, M. Lacroix, 3 votes. Collingwood versus St Kilda. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 1 vote. St Kilda, L. Montagna, 2 votes. St Kilda, L. Hayes, 3 votes.
So Gary Ablett at the moment and Nick Del Santo holding sway, both with 12 votes apiece. It's worth remembering, of course, that Gary misses 3 games throughout the season. And the only person in the last 40 years who's missed 3 games and won the Brownlow is one Tony Liberatore. So we'll see if Gary can rewrite the record books in that department. A short break, but as we go to the break, some of the truly great marks of the season.
Ben Logan's got the shot. It takes a screamer.
Oh,
it's
going to be a tough challenge for me.
Bugs me about the Brownlow. I've got no problem with recent winners of the medal, particularly classy on balls with a turn of pace and wonderful speed, kicking goals from anywhere, on either foot. Geez, they're pretty to watch. Hi, Lauren. My problem is, why don't blondes catch the umpires eye anymore? I mean, whatever happened to good old days when tips and highlights is a guarantee 3 votes? Now, take this specimen here. I mean, with a little bit more blonde tips and perhaps a whole blonde hair and maybe shave the sides, this guy too might be able to win a Brownlow one day.
Another Brownlow.
Yeah.
And I'm actually quite proud of my ginger heritage.
Yeah, whatever. I mean, think about 99, Shane Crawford won. 2000, Shane Woe Woden won. And this guy in 2001, I mean, what a natural blonde. I mean, he must have had a great relationship with his stylist.
They needed some magic from somewhere.
Sadly, I was the last blonde to win a Brownlow medal. I mean, these are dark days indeed. I mean, even Gaz has got rid of those golden locks. I mean, whew, I hate to think he'd regret getting rid of that Spanish comb-over. Gazza, I've checked the record books, and it turns out no skinheads ever won the Brownlow.
Well, things might change tonight. The irrepressible Acker, certainly one of the great characters of the game. As we now move to round 8, let's see how the hairy and the not-so-hairy fare.
Scotland the Brave.
The brave-hearted Blues ruled the skies and the Pies to claim a 51-point win over the old enemy.
That is so good.
And soaring at the highest altitude was Captain Jack.
Oh. We love this.
The Dockers too tried to fly.
Hey, put on your Superman cake, boy. It's Wolfie time, let's go.
But it was Super Buddy who had the final say.
Buddy, you beauty.
Just for something new, the Battle of the Swans and Eagles was decided by a kick.
Kieran Jack, the man who kicked the winner.
It was a confusing week at Tigerland. The media had it that Terry Wallace was sacked, but he wasn't.
There was no point in time when Terry wasn't the coach of Richmond.
While on the field, the Tigers thought they'd finally won. But they hadn't.
Round 8 of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Fremantle versus Hawthorn. Fremantle, M. Johnson, 1 vote. Hawthorn, B. Sewell, 2 votes. Hawthorn, C. Bateman, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, J. Akamanis, 1 vote. Melbourne, P. Johnson, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, M. Boyd, 3 votes. Geelong versus North Melbourne. Geelong, H. Taylor, 1 vote. Geelong, Jay Corey, 2 votes. Geelong, Jay Selwood, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Adelaide. Brisbane, M. Clark, 1 vote. Brisbane, T. Johnston, 2 votes. Brisbane, S. Black, 3 votes. Sydney versus West Coast. Sydney, J. McVeigh, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Hall, 2 votes. Sydney, A. Goods, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Richmond. Port Adelaide, T. Boak, 1 vote. Richmond, R. Nahas, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Carlton. Carlton, J. Waite, 1 vote. Carlton, B. Gibbs, 2 votes. Carlton, C. Judd, 3 votes. St. Kilda versus Essendon. St. Kilda, J. Kaczynski, 1 vote. Essendon, J. Watson, 2 votes. St. Kilda, L. Hayes, 3 votes.
Indigenous around, and Adelaide wins for Andrew McLeod in his Crows record-breaking game.
One of their favourite sons.
It was a good week for favourite sons. Tarkin Lockyer and Lenny Hayes, both winners in their 200th game.
One for the ages.
And there was love too for Acker, whose 300th was just one kick away from the fairy tale finish.
He's missed. Johnson has missed.
With a 55-point win over Port, it was a day to remember for Sydney.
Oh,
Heath Grundy.
That's near the mark of the year, isn't it?
That is a screamer.
Dreamtime at the G.
Oh, he's been the king of the year tonight.
And the Bombers were dreaming they could fly.
Oh, right. There's been some serious leaps tonight.
While for Tiger fans, the nightmare continued. They say in any weather you will see them with a grin. Not this week.
It's sad, isn't it?
Round 9. Geelong versus Western Bulldogs. Geelong, J. Selwood, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, J. Akamanis, 2 votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Fremantle. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 1 vote. North Melbourne, D. Hale, 2 votes. North Melbourne, D. Petrie, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Carlton. Carlton, M. Murphy, 1 vote. Adelaide, T. Edwards, 2 votes. Adelaide, C. Knights, 3 votes. West Coast versus Collingwood. Collingwood, D. Swan, 1 vote. Collingwood, L. Davis, 2 votes. Collingwood, N. Maxwell, 3 votes. Richmond versus Essendon. Richmond, S. Tuck, 1 vote. Essendon, P. Ryder, 2 votes. Essendon, J. Windelick, 3 votes. Sydney versus Port Adelaide. Sydney, A. Goods, 1 vote. Sydney, J. McVeigh, 2 votes. Sydney, B. Kirk, 3 votes. St. Kilda versus Brisbane. St. Kilda, L. Hayes, 1 vote. St. Kilda, L. Montagna, 2 votes. Brisbane, J. Brennan, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Melbourne. Hawthorn, B. Sewell, 1 vote. Hawthorn, J. Lewis, 2 votes. Melbourne, C. Sylvia, 3 votes.
Thank you, Andrew, and I think you'll agree, ladies and gentlemen, this is developing into a very, very exciting count. As we have a look at the leaderboard as it stands at the moment, you might like to make a note of the green ticks where our experts have predicted that the players with those in those rounds could pick up votes. Gary Ablett currently leading by 3 with 15. Nick Del Sando, if that flying start, is on 12. Lenny Hayes, his teammate, 10. Brad Sewell of the Hawks is on 9. They are our top four. Behind them, Jonathan Brown, Bryce Gibbs, Jared McVeigh and Mark Murphy of the Blues, all on 8 votes. As we head to the break once again, here's Lee and also Nathan Buckley with our next Orient contender, Adam Goods, who's certainly hit his straps.
Goods, oh, lovely!
Adam Goods is quite unique. He's got the power overhead to match the key position players, but he's got the run and the ball getting out wide to do it as a midfielder. He's always been a great headache for opposition coaches.
He's gone forward more often than not this year and been able to hit the scoreboard.
Now Goods going back, left foot, oh, he's a beauty, all right, Goods!
What more can you say about Adam Goods? He's run a couple of Brownlows. He's a brilliant player at his best and really does play three-vote games.
He's missed the unmissable goal.
In 09, the unmissable was always missable.
He's missed! Oh, no.
As they missed in front of goal, up the field,
whoa,
and past. passing to mates.
He's caught a teammate flush on the beak.
Catching with no hands was not only a hard trick to master, but also a health hazard.
This is not how you want to mark a ball.
Both the players and their families. And if the ball didn't get you, a teammate surely would.
It was like the Three Stooges there.
But there's nothing worse than getting caught with your pants down. Except, of course, getting caught with ants in your pants.
I think I might have said it all about 20 years ago. What more can you say after seeing that? As we head into round 10, one of tonight's hot favourites produced a reasonable 48 disposal game.
The Big Eagle landed in Perth, but it was a different kind of bird making headlines. Cousins clearly happy to be home. The Subi fans, if not happy, were at least clear. To play on or not to play on was again the question for Mitch Morton.
He didn't let the coach down that time.
5 goals to Crows teenager Taylor Walker clipped the Hawks' wings, and another win for the Lions landed Brisbane in the fourth. It was party time for the Blues as Fev's mojo returned to kick 6 goals.
Fev gets the goal.
Ditto for Steve Johnson, who was just too hot for the Bombers to handle.
Nobody in the competition right now is playing better than Johnson.
And 48 disposals from Dane Swan had the footy world singing his praises. Well, most of the footy world.
So he had a reasonable game.
Round 10 of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Carlton versus West Coast. Carlton, B for Vola, 1 vote. Carlton, M Murphy, 2 votes. Carlton, C Judd, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Sydney. Sydney, B Hall, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, S Higgins, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, D Giansiracusa, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Brisbane. Brisbane, S Black, 1 vote. North Melbourne, A Simpson, 2 votes. Brisbane, J Adcock, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Richmond. Richmond, S Tuck, 1 vote. Fremantle, A Sanderlands, 2 votes. Richmond, R Tambling, 3 votes. St Kilda versus Melbourne. St Kilda, N Revolt, 1 vote. St Kilda, L Montagna, 2 votes. St Kilda, L Hayes, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Hawthorne. Adelaide, T Walker, 1 vote. Adelaide, N Bock, 2 votes. Adelaide, S. Thompson, 3 votes. Essendon versus Geelong. Geelong, G. Ablett, 1 vote. Geelong, S. Johnson, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Selwood, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Port Adelaide. Collingwood, S. Pendlebury, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, D. Cassisi, 2 votes. Collingwood, D. Swan, 3 votes.
And for Terry, well, no tomorrow.
It was a week for goodbyes and hellos.
Jack Watts' first moment in the big league.
The Magpie Bullies showing the new boy who was boss of the MCG playground.
Another one right to the goal square.
350s from Bazza had the Swans going back. Jamie McNamara, however, did it his own way.
He's gone the wrong way, McNamara. Burns will goal as a result. He went the wrong way, McNamara.
Kurt Tippett was flying.
Oh.
His 7 goals helping send Tyson Edwards out a winner in his 300.
He's just been outstanding.
8 for Fev.
He's hot and getting hot.
And the Blues were once again coming.
Who else but Chris Jones?
That is the Ben Cousins camera, of course.
Another Cousins cam gag. But not all were laughing.
I bet that's a nervous Sean, I think.
And if they were nerves, then this fella was close to a breakdown.
A security guard in the Collingwood box.
Round 11, Richmond versus Western Bulldogs. Richmond, D. Jackson, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, S. Higgins, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, A. Cooney, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus St Kilda. St Kilda, J. Graham, 1 vote. St Kilda, J. Kaczynski, 2 votes. St Kilda, L. Hayes, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Carlton. Carlton, C. Judd, 1 vote. Brisbane, S. Black, 2 votes. Carlton, B for Vola, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Fremantle. Fremantle, S Hill, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, J Surgeon, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, D Roden, 3 votes. Essendon versus Adelaide. Adelaide, C Knights, 1 vote. Adelaide, K Tippett, 2 votes. Adelaide, T Edwards, 3 votes. Hawthorne versus Sydney. Hawthorne, B McGlynn, 1 vote. Sydney, A Goods, 2 votes. Hawthorne, S Mitchell, 3 votes. West Coast versus Geelong. Geelong, J Selwood, 1 vote. West Coast, D Cox, 2 votes. Geelong, G Ablett, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Collingwood. Collingwood, B Dick, 1 vote. Melbourne, C Sylvia, 2 votes. Collingwood, S Pendlebury, 3 votes.
Lenny Hayes enjoying a rich vein of form at the moment. This is the most he's ever polled in a Brownlow, 16 votes, but he trails Gary Ablett, who is currently our leader on 19. Nick Del Santo taking votes from Lenny, or Lenny's taking them from Nick. He's on 12, and Chris Judd has moved to 11. While on another page, as we look back, a number of contenders are just a couple away, but it is Lenny at the moment who is throwing down the challenge to one Gary Ablett. Well, a couple of blokes who aren't polling too well, but are footy legends in their own lifetime, join us now. Would you please make welcome Dave Lawson and Steve Curry for their take on the season.
Yes, thank you, Sandals. Look, here we are at table 777. Right up the back of the 2009 Brownlow medal count.
This is actually the Toyota Legends table. Ladies and gentlemen, oh, what a feeling.
I don't think it's the Toyota Legends table, Dave.
What do you mean?
I just reckon the Toyota Legends table is probably going to have a tablecloth on it. And maybe like some chairs and stuff.
You can't just get a tablecloth and chairs. You've got to earn them to become a legend, mate.
What do you need to do?
Well, you need speed.
Mm-hmm.
You need agility.
Yep.
You need passion.
Mm-hmm.
And most importantly, you need hand-eye coordination.
Cool.
Just like this. Have a look.
Yeah, I can see what you're saying there, Dave. That is making me think that maybe, can we get a tablecloth here and just a couple of chairs?
You know, if you want the tablecloth and chairs, you've got to have some ball handling skills.
Really? Bit of touch.
You need a bit of touch. Watch how Fev does it. Check this out.
Good to see Fev finding an untouch. And that speaks for itself, actually.
That's not his best view.
Now, Brendan Favola's hanging back near the goal square, just adjusting a few things.
That's how you do it.
No, I've got it. Can we get just a tablecloth, maybe just a couple of chairs?
You still, mate, to become a legend, to sit on a table with a tablecloth and chairs.
Yeah.
We're missing one thing. We don't actually play for a football club.
You're telling me you have to be playing for a football club to be a footy legend?
Yeah.
You're an idiot.
Yeah, and once you make it, you've got to be passionate about that club.
Right, so respect the emblem?
You've got to respect the emblem, especially when you're singing the team song. Mm. Watch how Geelong does it. See?
No, that's it. That's respect. That is respect personified right there. No, that's great. Can we get just a quick tablecloth here?
But can I just show you, before we do get the tablecloth and the chairs, can I show you one last bit of footage?
Okay.
This is what it takes to become a legend. Watch this. You see that? See what I've done there?
I see what you've done, but that...
Yeah.
What? I mean, why?
It's just, I thought a dog humping a leg in slow motion over dramatic music might be funny.
All right, well, we're not going to be back after this, obviously, but after the break, stick around because there is going to be some classic commentary moments from 2009.
And welcome back to Crown Palladium, wherever you may be viewing. I certainly hope you're enjoying what is turning out to be a very, very exciting telecast. The Saints were excited on Friday night after that narrow but thrilling win over the gutsy Western Bulldogs. As we move into the second half of the season, it was a couple of former Brownlow medalists and a couple of young stars who left their mark in round 12.
It was nothing but smiles this week for the friend in the van, not to mention his old teammates.
They both had a smile. Well, that's good to see.
The Eagles unveiled their new number 9.
That knew he flew high.
While at the Demons, the initiated Walbury man, Liam Jarrett, was admitted to AFL footy.
Oh, he's going to kick a goal.
Jade Rawlings began his coaching career with a win, and Grandpa Mick was singing after his Pies beat the Swans in his 600th game as coach. The Hawks stumbled in Tassie, Jonathan Brown booting 5 to lead the Lions to victory.
And kick from Brown.
An inspirational Chris Judd earned himself a new nickname.
Now on is Chris Blood.
But it was Zach Dawson who became the unlikely hero.
Never ever going to miss.
Rained on Adam Simpson's 300 game parade.
Adam Simpson in game 300, disappointed again. He has been a star.
And after 6.5 years at the Roos, Dean Laidley had enough.
It became patently obvious to me that it was time to move on.
Round 12 of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Richmond versus West Coast. West Coast, M. Prittis, 1 vote. Richmond, R. Tamling, 2 votes. Richmond, N. Foley, 3 votes. Essendon versus Melbourne. Essendon, A. McPhee, 1 vote. Essendon, S. Lucas, 2 votes. Essendon, J. Watson, 3 votes. Adelaide versus North Melbourne. Adelaide, A. Otten, 1 vote. Adelaide, S. Thompson, 2 votes. Adelaide, M. Doughty, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Port Adelaide. Western Bulldogs, J. Akamanis, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, D. Cross, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, S. Higgins, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Brisbane. Brisbane, J. Brennan, 1 vote. Brisbane, J. Brown, 2 votes. Brisbane, S. Black, 3 votes. Sydney versus Collingwood. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, 2 votes. Collingwood, A. Didak, 3 votes. Carlton versus St. Kilda. St. Kilda, L. Montagna, 1 vote. Carlton, K. Simpson, 2 votes. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Geelong. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, 1 vote. Geelong, C. Ling, 2 votes. Geelong, S. Burns, 3 votes.
Of love for Andrew Lovett, who pulled out all his tricks in the Bombers' 69-point win over the Blues.
Lovett, yes!
The Pies too were on a high, turning the members' wing at the G into a black and white highway.
One of the goals of the year!
Willingham from Hardiff against the light. He says to Harry O'Brien, I can beat you!
There was a new voice at the Roos. But it wasn't enough to bring the Doggies down. Big Bad Bazza was hearing bells again.
And he's been reported very hard for strikes.
Yes. Shoot.
But this week, no one was bigger than Nick Natanui.
Can he do the miraculous? He does!
His 3 final quarter goals finishing the Hawks and announcing the birth of a new star.
That's to 45, and he dribbles one through.
How good was that?
Round 13, Brisbane versus Melbourne. Brisbane, L. Power, 1 vote. Brisbane, J. Brown, 2 votes. Brisbane, S. Black, 3 votes. West Coast versus Hawthorn. West Coast, N. Natanui, 1 vote. West Coast, M. Prittis, 2 votes. West Coast, Q. Lynch, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Sydney. Adelaide, J. Porplesia, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, 2 votes. Adelaide, B. Vince, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Fremantle. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 1 vote. Collingwood. D. Swan, 2 votes. Collingwood. A. Didak, 3 votes. Essendon versus Carlton. Essendon. A. Munfries, 1 vote. Essendon. D. Fletcher, 2 votes. Essendon. A. Welsh, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs. R. Murphy, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs. D. Gian Siracusa, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs. M. Boyd, 3 votes. St Kilda versus Richmond. St Kilda. J. Graham, 1 vote. St Kilda. J. Kaczynski, 2 votes. St Kilda. B. Goddard, 3 votes. Geelong versus Port Adelaide. Geelong. J. Bartell, 1 vote. Geelong. P. Chapman, 2 votes. Geelong. G. Ablett, 3 votes.
Rebecca, I'll ask you this question because I know Chris won't answer this question at all. What sort of a second half to the season did he have?
I think it was okay, yeah. But I'm definitely expecting Gaz to win it. So good luck to him, and I think he's due.
Chris, he's going to be hard to chase down from here.
Yeah, you think so? He's polled really well, and you know there probably wouldn't be a more deserving winner in the room.
What sort of a life-changing experience is it to win a Brownlow?
I guess, especially living in Perth, life was relatively private. I guess, you win a Brownlow and you have a girlfriend strutting around in a red dress. Things were pretty public after that.
Now, Feb, who's just sitting next to you, wants to know how you can kick 8 goals in a game and still not get a vote.
He's just making his way over to Andrew Demetrio's table at the minute, and he's got a few ideas for him.
Cats and Saints are two best sides on Saturday afternoon. Who wins?
I think the Saints will get up in a close one.
Thanks, Chris. Thanks, Rebecca.
Thank you, Tim, Chris and Rebecca, as we now move to round 14, which was highlighted by an epic match between the Saints and the Cats.
It was an emotional day at the G as the Demons rose up for their president, Tim Starr.
Love you, big fella, and I guess that one's for you.
The famous old dark canary yellows celebrated a come-from-behind win at Subi.
And I think the Blues won, and Brendan does too.
While it was the Port runner doing the celebrating after this Jared Brennan brain fade.
Who could be more excited for Josh Carr's winning head?
The Doggies were so hot they were smoking. The Hawks cooked 88-4 at half-time before their fangs continued the grilling. But this week was all about the clash of the Titans. After 13 weeks and 2 hours, still nothing could split the unbeaten Cats and Saints. Enter Michael Gardner. The former bad boy confirming he was now definitely a Saint.
Round 14. Melbourne versus West Coast. Melbourne. N. Jones, 1 vote. Melbourne. B. Maloney, 2 votes. Melbourne. J. Grimes, 3 votes. Richmond versus Adelaide. Richmond. R. Nahas, 1 vote. Adelaide. K. Tippett, 2 votes. Adelaide S. Thompson, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Brisbane. Port Adelaide R. Gray, 1 vote. Port Adelaide B. Ebert, 2 votes. Port Adelaide D. Roden, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Hawthorn. Western Western Bulldogs R. Hargrave, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs M. Boyd, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs R. Griffin, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Essendon. Collingwood, D. Swan, 1 vote. Collingwood, J. Cloak, 2 votes. Collingwood, J. Fraser, 3 votes. Sydney versus North Melbourne. North Melbourne, J. Gibson, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, 2 votes. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Carlton. Carlton, S. O'Halpin, 1 vote. Carlton, C. Judd, 2 votes. Carlton, B. Gibbs, 3 votes. St Kilda versus Geelong. St Kilda. N. Revol, one vote. Geelong. J. Bartell, two votes. St Kilda. M. Gardner, three votes.
Fascinating situation after round 14. As we check the leaderboard, we find Gary Ablett still leading. This time he's stretched that margin to six votes. On 22, Lenny Hayes is 16. Chris Judd has moved to 13 votes. Simon Black always polls well and has got some good games left in the tank, is on 12 with Jonathan Brown and Nick Del Santo. Matthew Boyd has started to move. He is on 11. And so too is Bryce Gibbs. Still lots more to come. Dennis Cometti is joining us shortly to chat with one of the all-time greats. But first, let's look and listen to some classic Cometti.
Jinsky, that was ambitious. That's ambitious.
That's ambitious, but it's okay.
Trying to soccer it through Alpen. That's his forte, the little toe poke.
Armfield. Well, that's a good kick. Goes to the fat side. That's ironic. He's bleeding. We need to get that blood off him very quickly. And what about that bloody Franklin? So that combination again for Vola Betts. That's a description, not a statement.
Jack kept coming, though. Jack's got the footy again. He plays footy like Army Jack. He wants to rip their bloody arms off. Marvellous.
Prez, David Smorgon. Must have thought his boys were back, but dare I say it, a stunned dog millionaire.
I'd been to night school, caught the train home, and it was on the radio, of course, and by the time I got to Griffin Crescent, you know, there seemed to be cars everywhere and people coming out of houses starting to say congratulations.
My father was listening to it on the radio. So then we all went around to Bob's home, to his mum and dad's.
3DB Melbourne, 3LKS, and fans, friends and neighbours have packed Bobby Skilton's Garden City home this evening after the announcement of his Brownlow medal win.
Down the road from the port ground, made the old port ground, you know, second home, so to speak, and everybody knew everybody. And
I didn't follow league football at all. I followed Port Melbourne everywhere, and I had actually only ever saw South Melbourne play once before I played with them.
When you got stitches over both eyes and had your nose broken twice in 2 weeks, you're not the prettiest sight in the world. But I was in bed watching combat on the telly, and at one stage I can remember Tommy Laiff. Everybody was out in the lounge, and Tommy Laiff came into the bedroom and said, "I don't want to muck up your television viewing," he said, "but you are in front."
I think I was out washing, hanging some washing on the line. And then I think it was Neil Roberts who rang and said, "I think you'd better get dressed and I'll lend you a pair of sunglasses."
I'll tell you one thing, Bob, here at TV ringside, I can say this honestly, you're amongst friends.
Yeah, well, I reckon I would have stopped it earlier.
Ron Casey suggested that I was giving the fight game a bad name, getting in the ring looking like that. Almost given up hope of seeing the red and white win one.
To the people who've waited 72 years, here it is!
To see guys like Bobby Skilton was just amazing, because I think then I realised how significant the moment was.
On the mantelpiece at home, Pride of Place is a replica of the Premiership Cup that the club sent me, with the team on it and my name, and that holds Pride of Place.
Bobby was a racehorse. He was a thoroughbred. He was a bloke who, more or less, very much ahead of his time.
His courage, his enormous ability, his concentration
always was on the ball.
To win 9 best and fairest at his club is just remarkable in itself, but then to be rewarded, you know, with his efforts across the league as being voted, you know, 3 times in different years that he's the best player in the league is a truly remarkable feat.
He always had a smile on his face, you know, even when he was unconscious, he had a smile on his face.
Well, everybody wants to be the best player. Even the under-11s go out wanting to be the best player. But what we all go out there for is for the team to win, and you hope that you're going to play in a premiership.
The real champion is Bobby Skilton.
Ah, yes, some remarkable memories. 50 years ago tonight, Bob Skilton won his first Brownlow medal. He won again in 1963 and 1968. Tonight, Bob is joined by his good mate and the 1969 Brownlow medalist, Kevin Murray. Ladies and gentlemen, indeed, it is football royalty. Bob Skilton and Kevin Murray. Kevin, excuse me.
Hey, Dennis.
Happy anniversary, Bob. 50 years.
Thanks very much. Shows how old we're getting.
Well, we all feel that, a lot of us in this room. Now, just something about the 60s. How did they and when did they count the votes? It was a meeting, wasn't it? And when was it held?
On the Monday after the last game. And the Brownlow was actually presented before the first semi.
Well, that vision we saw just moments ago, what happened 2 days before? you found out you've won that night and you turned up looking like that. I presume something happened.
Yeah, well, I went into the last game with 2 black eyes because I had my nose broken against Footscray.
Yeah.
And then we played Collingwood the last game, and just before half-time, I did mark the kick in from full-back, and John Rantel was going to mark it at the same time. And my teammate and I hit heads, and... He broke my nose again and opened up my right eye. So they stitched that up at half time because we had no blood rule in and whatever. And then in the third quarter, my great mate Len Thompson, I ran into a Len Thompson Shepherd, and he opened up the left eye. So
a former Brownlow medalist.
So, you know, you win them, you wear them.
Yeah, Kevin, nothing you hear there surprises you, obviously.
Well, Dennis, I just want to say one little thing tonight is that I want to thank you all you people out here, all you supporters, because believe me, without you making the game what it is today, none of us would have achieved what we did in our time. Thank you.
Well put. Let's talk about the game in your time, Kevin, because you did something rather unusual. You left Fitzroy for a couple of years, played in Western Australia, came back and won your Brownlow.
Yes, Dennis, well, I'd run second in my 6th season and equal second in my 8th season. And then in my 14th season, I ran third. In my 15th season, I won the Brownlow medal. But I'd played 10 years at Fitzroy and went and coached East Perth for 2 years as captain and coached the West Australian side. But I definitely did come back to Victoria, a better player. And I had an average year in 67. I ran third to Bobby in 68. But I was very lucky to win the Brownlow in 69. And you know why, Dennis?
I think I know the answer, but you tell me.
Bobby Skilton never played that year.
The reason I know that answer is Bob told me that.
He had an Achilles problem and never played the whole season, so I was very lucky to get it.
Just a final question, Kev. If you got the Brownlow around your neck
it's
tonight?
It's right here. It's close to my heart. It was hard to win, but all the supporters and my teammate helped me win this, and always like to share it with the people because they're the people that helped me get it.
Shades of 1969. Kevin Murray. And Bob, just a question in terms of both of you guys. You've expressed your love, you're on record for the game as it is today, and you both embraced relocation. Did that cost you any friends?
Oh, look, we weren't happy when it happened. We thought we'd lost our side, and but in reality, we would have folded, and today I wouldn't have a side at all. And I think the banner before we won the premiership in 2005 summed everything up. 2 cities, 1 team, and it has worked well. We're 8,500 members down here in Melbourne, and the players love it when they come down. There's a lot of red and white around, and we've still got a footy side.
Well, as Ron Casey said, you're amongst friends. Ladies and gentlemen, two of the greats, Bob Skilton and Kevin Murray.
Every game, really good in close, gets the ball heaps, out wide as well, and really good and powerful in the overhead marking contest.
There's been times when he's been knocked for his skills, but having played with him and watched him over the last couple of years, he's as effective as anyone.
Yes, it was about this stage of the season that the Collingwood running machine, Dane Swan, really did get into top gear. But let's have a look at the Orion leaderboard before we move on to our next round. Gary Ablett shows the way. He leads by 6 votes. And the last time, the only time anyone has scored 22 votes after 14 rounds was Robert Harvey back in 1998. So Gary is in very good company there. Behind him is Lenny Hayes on 16, Chris Judd 13. Simon Black has polled 12 votes. On our second page, we see Jonathan Brown also on 12 with Nick Del Santo. Matthew Boyd has done well for the Western Bulldogs. He is on 11. And Bryce Gibbs has 11 for Carlton. And so now we move to round 15. And it kicked off with a thriller between the Pies and the Dogs.
Collingwood's going to win it.
It was the Pies by a point over the Dogs. And the bookies were reeling as Alan Gydak and Dane Swan once again starred.
An unfamiliar feeling for the Cats.
The Cats found out how two straight losses feel. The D's too in uncharted waters with consecutive wins.
Jarrah!
As Liam Jarrah gave the term rising star a new meaning.
Jarrah's done it again! For a career best, 9 goals!
It was the Fev show at the G.
Oh, my!
And he was more than happy to tell everyone about.
Football's going, did you see it, Newman?
Tassie turned on its finest weather as Buddy turned on his finest form.
He couldn't, could he? Girl. Oh, yes, he can!
4 final quarter goals, confirming the crown still fits.
The King lives!
Round 15, the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Melbourne, Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, T. Thurston's 1 vote. Port Adelaide, D. Cassisi, 2 votes. Melbourne, B. Maloney, 3 votes. Hawthorne versus North Melbourne. Hawthorne, S. Mitchell, 1 vote. North Melbourne, A. Swallow, 2 votes. Hawthorne, B. Sewell, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Fremantle. Adelaide, K. Tippett, 1 vote. Adelaide, A. Otten, 2 votes. Adelaide, S. Thompson, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Collingwood. Western Bulldogs, B. Lake, 1 vote. Collingwood, L. Davis, 2 votes. Collingwood, A. Didak, 3 votes. Sydney versus Essendon. Essendon, M. Lloyd, 1 vote. Sydney, A. Goods, 2 votes. Essendon, J. Windelick, 3 votes. Carlton versus Richmond. Richmond, D. Jackson, 1 vote. Carlton, B. Favola, 2 votes. Carlton, C. Judd, 3 votes. West Coast versus St Kilda. West Coast, D. Glass, 1 vote. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 2 votes. St Kilda, L. Montagna, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Geelong. Brisbane, J. Brown, 1 vote. Brisbane, A. McGrath, 2 votes. Brisbane, D. Rich, 3 votes.
What about this bloke?
The Brownlow have a new favour as Captain Judd led the Blues to a 61-point win over the Swans.
Carlton on fire.
The Saints were again in sync, ticking over their 16th win to end the Crows' 7-game run. Although they did have some luck on the way.
One of the more amazing
amazing goals you will see in AFL football.
Hot pies were on the menu for the Hawks. And with Luke Hodge back in the midfield, it was Hawthorn by 45.
An exquisite move from the Hawks. Goes through for a magnificent goal.
There was an unusual carrot on offer for the Tigers and Roos.
This game is very much like a Nathan Buckley fertility dance.
But the battle for Rawlings brothers' bragging rights was a stalemate.
First draw for the season, and for Mr. and Mrs. Rawlings, perfect.
Round 16. Port Adelaide versus West Coast Eagles. Port Adelaide, D. Roden, one vote. Port Adelaide, K. Corns, two votes. Port Adelaide, J. Davenport, three votes. Richmond versus North Melbourne. North Melbourne, H. McIntosh, one vote. Richmond, C. Newman, two votes. North Melbourne, B. Harvey, three votes. Essendon versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, D. Cross, one vote. Western Bulldogs, S. Higgins, two votes. Western Bulldogs, M. Hahn, three votes. Fremantle versus Brisbane. Fremantle, K. Bradley, one vote. Brisbane, J. Brown, two votes. Brisbane, D. Rich, three votes. Collingwood versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, B. Guerra, one vote. Hawthorn, L. Franklin, two votes. Hawthorn, L. Hodge, three votes. Carlton versus Sydney. Carlton, M. Cruiser, one vote. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, two votes. Carlton, K. Simpson, three votes. St. Kilda versus Adelaide. St. Kilda, B. Goddard, one vote. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, two votes. St. Kilda, F. Ray, three votes. Geelong versus Melbourne. Geelong, G. Ablett, one vote. Geelong, P. Chapman, two votes. Geelong, M. Scarlett, three votes.
So after round 16, let's have a look at our leaderboard, and you'll note that Gary Ablett has stretched his lead by one further vote. He now leads by seven from Lenny Hayes. Chris Judd is on 16, and it's a mighty effort by Chris because for the sixth consecutive year, he has polled 15 votes or more. It's an outstanding achievement. Jonathan Brown, polling extremely well as well, is on 15 votes. But I wonder how the favourites are faring. We'll have a look at that now. Well, Gary Ablett is the favourite, and he's certainly faring extremely well at the moment. Dane Swan is coming into a purple patch, but he's going to have to get his skates on. He's currently in 22nd spot. Chris Judd is polling well. Adam Goods is in the top 10. So too is Nick Del Santo. But Gary Ablett shows the way with 23 votes with just six rounds remaining. So that's how the leaderboard stands, as I said, after round 16. Now we're going to join Tim Watson once again on the floor with the Lions captain, who's polling pretty well, Jonathan Brown.
Well, Jono, you're only eighth in the lead. You could win this.
Yeah, I'm a good chance. I'm just writing the speech now, Timmy. So.
Who are you going to thank?
Well, obviously thank Kylie first, who's been the butt of all my jokes in the last week, who's 6 weeks pregnant and due on Melbourne Cup Day, if you haven't heard. 6 weeks to go, sorry. But I'll have to give my mum a mention, who hasn't spoken to me for the last week.
And was that after your All-Australian speech, was it?
Yeah, it was. I was just trying to liven the night up a bit, Tim. There was some pretty stock-standard answers. Obviously, all the boys hadn't had as many drinks as I had on that Monday night. Obviously, they were all in the finals, but it was a good night. A
few rounds to go. How do you finish the season off?
I kicked eight against North, so I'm hoping I might be able to jag a vote there. that might be... that's about it, I reckon.
And what about Saturday? Who do you like out of the Cats and the Saints?
Oh, I think the Cats, just because they had it a little bit easier in the second half, and you know, the game Friday night was the most intense game I've ever seen, I reckon. Both sides would be absolutely buggered after that, and it just depends how St Kilda recovers. I think St Kilda deserve to win it. They've been the best team all year, but Geelong are looking ominous. They've got all their best players, they've got all their players back on the paddock, so it's going to be a great game.
Good luck. Enjoy the rest of the night.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you, Tim. Round 17 coming up very, very soon. But as we go to the break, let's take it now with some of the great goals of the season.
From the pocket, that is as good as it gets from the genius.
Brown going back with an old teammate.
Buddy, could he do it? Could he do it? Is there anything the man can't do?
Rodens. And Rodens away.
Good set. Nice shimmy. He might go all the way here. He's kicked a couple of these last week.
I reckon they probably come here thinking, no, we're going to have a real bad one today in the first quarter. What do you honestly think?
You're not listening, are you?
They reckon they come to play marbles.
So what's your question?
You answer the question.
Look, I feel like I've answered that question.
You tell me.
Well, it's time to move on.
I think a lot of people are going to miss him.
Tell that kid to get out of the way.
Have a look at Mark Williams serving it up.
This is as angry as he's seen.
Ross Lyons rang me.
How about that?
What do you want me to say?
That's just unbelievable.
Very fortunate to have the greatest player that's ever played to present this jumper. Thanks, Michael. No worries, Michael.
Well, Ross, we saw some of the coaches under pressure then. What's it like grand final week for a coach?
Obviously, we're early in the week, Tim. You know, big outcomes, a lot of functions, and we want to enjoy the week, but we've certainly got to focus on what we do best, which is prepare for games of AFL footy, and not too much will change other than the obvious.
Well, a number of your boys have polled well tonight. That would be no surprise to you.
Oh, look, it's great to see them get some recognition. You know, it's a fantastic award, and you know, but you know, obviously Gary Ablett Jr. right on top there, and a number of our mids, and you know, anyone would be a deserving winner.
And what about the rest of the week? What have you got planned?
Oh, as a you know, open training session tomorrow. A lot of Saints fans get along. It's great for the club. You know, it's a game we want to be in. But we just need to stay, you know, focused on our actions and prepare really well. And, you know, we're coming up against a great team, three times grand final, but we feel we've had a really strong year and we want to come and put on a good show.
Thanks for your time tonight. Good luck at the weekend.
Thanks, Tim. Cheers.
Thank you, Tim, and good luck to Ross Lyon and the Saints come Saturday afternoon. Incidentally, you'll see Ross Lyon and also Geelong coach Bomber Thompson on Game Day Season's Best. We've been talking about this. It's on 7 on Wednesday night prime time as once again we check the Orion leaderboard, and it's looking good, isn't it, for Gary Ablett at the moment. He's on 23 votes. Lenny Hayes is on 16. Chris Judd is on 16. Jonathan Brown is on 15. And for Brown, Hayes and Ablett, that is the most they have polled in a Brownlow on one night. So they're having stellar seasons. Nick Del Santo is on 14 votes. Simon Black, with a couple of good games to go, is on 12, as is Lee Montagna and also Brad Sewell. Right, let's move on because we approach the business end of the season with round 17, and it featured a classic between last year's grand finalists.
For number 8 for the night.
Rivalry round saw the big stars shine.
Brilliant.
From the Brown show in Brisbane to Buddy's exhibition at the G.
Is there anything the man can do?
Joel Selwood racked up 42 possessions, but it came down to one kick from Jimmy Bartel.
He's kicked a point! The best point he'll ever kick!
Nick Revolt bagged 5.
Oh, that's a magnificent goal!
Ditto for Stevie Milne, who put his own spin on things. With 38 disposals, it was Dane Swan's night too. While Leon Leon gave his tagger Aaron Joseph a Technicolor night.
Leon Davis, high fives all around.
Round 17, the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Essendon versus Richmond. Richmond, T. Cochin, one vote. Richmond, B. Cousins, two votes. Richmond, Jay Revolt, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Adelaide, M. Doughty, 1 vote. Adelaide, N. Bock, 2 votes. Adelaide, B. Riley, 3 votes. Fremantle versus West Coast. West Coast, M. Prittis, 1 vote. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, 2 votes. Fremantle, A. Sandilands, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Sydney. Sydney, D. Jolly, 1 vote. Sydney, R. Shaw, 2 votes. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, 3 votes. Carlton versus Collingwood. Collingwood, S. Prestigiacomo, 1 vote. Collingwood, L. Davis, 2 votes. Collingwood, D. Swan, 3 votes. Brisbane versus North Melbourne. Brisbane, J. Sherman, 1 vote. Brisbane, M. Clark, 2 votes. Brisbane, J. Brown, 3 votes. Geelong versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, B. Sewell, 1 vote. Hawthorn, L. Franklin, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Selwood, 3 votes. St. Kilda versus Western Bulldogs. St. Kilda, B. Goddard, 1 vote. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, 2 votes. St. Kilda, L. Hayes, 3 votes.
That's a pretty special moment.
For the Bulldogs record breaker, Brad Johnson, it was 342 not active. But for Adam Simpson, after 15 years and 306 games, it was over and out.
This is a special night.
The Brownlow had a new favourite as Dane Swan racked up another 36 disposals, while Leon Davis racked up another contender for Goal of the Year. But round 18 was all about the last-minute thrill.
6 for Chappie.
It was a happy Chappie getting the Cats home by 2 points. With 30 seconds on the clock, Ali Montagna behind did it for the Saints.
Saints in front!
While Jordan McMahon got his shot at glory after the siren.
The Tigers in a thriller!
Yep, a thriller. Just ask the Tiger coaches.
Round 18, Melbourne versus Richmond. Richmond, B. Deledio, 1 vote. Melbourne, J. McDonald, 2 votes. Richmond, B. Cousins, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, C. Rioli, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, T. Boak, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, R. Gray, 3 votes. West Coast Eagles versus Essendon. West Coast, A. Selwood, 1 vote. West Coast, D. Glass, 2 votes. West Coast, M. Lacroix, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Fremantle. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, D. Cross, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, J. Akamanis, 3 votes. North Melbourne versus Carlton. Carlton, M. Murphy, 1 vote. Carlton, N. Stevens, 2 votes. Carlton, B. Gibbs, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Brisbane. Brisbane, J. Brown, 1 vote. Collingwood, L. Davis, 2 votes. Collingwood, S. Pendlebury, 3 votes. Sydney versus St. Kilda. St. Kilda, L. Montagna, 1 vote. Sydney, J. McVeigh, 2 votes. St. Kilda, B. Goddard, 3 votes. Geelong versus Adelaide. Geelong. P. Chapman, one vote. Geelong. J. Selwood, two votes. Geelong. J. Bartell, three votes.
So things starting to really warm up with just four rounds remaining as we check our leaderboard. Gary Abbott's lead has been cut from 7-4. Jonathan Brown has moved to 19 votes and has a share of second place with Lenny Hayes, both on 19 votes. Chris Judd is on 16. Whilst over the page and looking to challenge, Nick Del Santo on 14 with Bryce Gibbs, Brendan Goddard and Joel Selwood, all on 14 votes. As I said, just four rounds remaining. We'll be back with those to see who can take out the coveted 2009 Brownlow medal. Welcome back to the Crown Palladium and this our coverage of the 2009 Brownlow medal. Let's check our leaderboard before we go any further. Four rounds remaining and it could be very, very tight at the top. Gary Ablett at the moment holds a four-vote lead. He did lead by seven. Jonathan Brown has come with a wet sail. He's on 19. Lenny Hayes on 19. Chris Judd is on 16. All of those players still in contention. So let's keep an eye on them as we move to round 19, which was, incidentally, a raft of upsets.
Round 19. Or the egg on the face round for tipsters. As 13th beat 3rd.
Victory at last for the West Coast Eagles.
And 15th toppled 8th.
And the Fremantle Dockers win game number 5 for the year.
The Roos were singing for the first time since May. And the Cats were licking their wounds as the Blues finally arrived.
The Blues are in the finals.
Finals looked a little closer too for the Bombers until the last 5 seconds.
Bradshaw! He's marked it,
and we'll get a draw.
The Brownlow man was in Brownlow form, and the Swans did it for Mickey O in his club record 300th game.
Honour him with a victory.
The Saints may have made 7 changes, but the scoreboard stayed just the same.
Just amazing.
And Buddy's 100th ended with a visit from the Tooth Fairy.
The nightmare 100th, goalless and toothless.
Round 19 of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Fremantle versus Port Adelaide. Fremantle, C Main, one vote. Fremantle, G Broughton, two votes. Fremantle, P Duffield, three votes. North Melbourne versus Melbourne. North Melbourne, D Petrie, one vote. North Melbourne, T Goldstein, two votes. North Melbourne, B Harvey, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus West Coast Eagles. West Coast, M Rosa, one vote. West Coast, S. Hearn, two votes. West Coast, A. Embley, three votes. Adelaide versus Collingwood. Adelaide, J. Porplesia, one vote. Collingwood, S. Pendlebury, two votes. Adelaide, A. McLeod, three votes. Essendon versus Brisbane. Brisbane, S. Black, one vote. Essendon, J. Watson, two votes. Brisbane, M. Clark, three votes. Richmond versus Sydney. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, one vote. Sydney, J. Bolton, two votes. Sydney, A. Goods, three votes. Hawthorn versus St. Kilda. St. Kilda, L. Ball, one vote. St. Kilda, S. Milne, two votes. St Kilda, D Armitage, three votes. Carlton versus Geelong. Carlton, C Judd, one vote. Geelong, J Selwood, two votes. Carlton, B Favola, three votes.
Thank you, Andrew. So the situation hasn't changed. Gary Ablett continues to lead, but it's getting very tight, very tense and very exciting. We'll go down to Gary now, who's been a front runner now for some considerable time. How are you feeling, Gary?
Yeah, I'm a little bit nervous. There's still a few rounds to go, so we'll see what happens.
Tell us briefly about your final three rounds. What was your form like? What are you expecting from the umpires?
I'm not really sure. I think I play right in a few of them, so hopefully, yeah, I can get a few votes. It'd be good.
Could be one of the understatements. Who knows? We might find out right after this break. We shall continue our coverage of this year's Brownlow Medal. Is our current leader, Gary Ablett, holding sway at the moment with just three rounds remaining as we now go to highlights of round 20, which, if my memory serves me correctly, was a beauty for our leader.
The MCG was no place for the faint-hearted, and the middle of a melee no place for a Brownlow favourite. But 34 disposals didn't do Dane Swan any harm. The Pies 93-point winners in Joel Bowden's 265th and final game.
Always sad to see them go, Malcolm.
It wasn't all beer and Skittles for Jono at the Gabba. Well, at least not Skittles. They belonged to Jesse White. The little master answered his critics with 44 disposals.
He hasn't given up yet.
The Cats over Sydney by less than one straight kick. And it was one straight kick that was needed to keep the Saints' unbeaten season alive.
He's missed. The place has gone bananas.
Round 20 of the Toyota AFL Premiership season. Melbourne versus Fremantle. Melbourne, S. Valenti, one vote. Melbourne, M. Bate, two votes. Melbourne, A. Davey, three votes. West Coast Eagles versus North Melbourne. West Coast, T. Houlihan, one vote. West Coast, A. Selwood, two votes. West Coast, M. Prittis, three votes. Hawthorne versus Adelaide. Adelaide, B. Rutten, one vote. Adelaide, A. McLeod, two votes. Adelaide, B. Vince, three votes. Richmond versus Collingwood. Collingwood, A. Didak, one vote. Collingwood, D. Beams, two votes. Collingwood, H. Shaw, three votes. Brisbane versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, M. Boyd, one vote. Western Bulldogs, J. Harbrow, two votes. Brisbane, S. Black, three votes. Essendon versus St. Kilda. St. Kilda, J. Kaczynski, one vote. Essendon, A. Mumfries, two votes. Essendon, J. Watson, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Carlton. Carlton, B. Gibbs, one vote. Carlton, C. Judd, two votes. Carlton, M. Murphy, three votes. Sydney versus Geelong. Sydney, R. Shaw, one vote. Geelong, J. Corey, two votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, three votes.
And that means, Gary, you can't be beaten. You now lead by seven votes with just two rounds remaining. Firstly, I'll say to you, we've got two rounds remaining, but congratulations.
Thanks, mate.
You were hoping the umpires might have picked up that performance, and they didn't let you down.
Yeah, look, I can't add up too well, so if you can just read the last two out, that'd be good.
Look, we'll let you gather your thoughts, but no worries. After 3 years, you're home and hosed. Think about it. We'll go to highlights now of round 21.
Forget about finals. What about pride?
For the second week running, morning, the siren sounded pain for the Saints.
Not again.
As it was deja vu.
It was touched!
The Dogs dished out loss number 4 for the Cats, but little Gaz still racked up big numbers with 40 possessions. Adam Goods also shone in the losing side, as the Pies and Brad Dick were once again on target.
Well, that's a dead eye.
But for Ben Cousins, it was more dead stiff than dead eye after this bump from Bunny.
He stopped Cousins in his tracks.
Round 21. Fremantle versus Essendon. Fremantle, Al McFarlane, 1 vote. Fremantle, A. Sandlands, 2 votes. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, 3 votes. Richmond versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, S. Mitchell, 1 vote. Richmond, B. Deledio, 2 votes. Hawthorn, L. Hodge, 3 votes. Adelaide versus West Coast. Adelaide, J. Portplesia, 1 vote. Adelaide, M. Dowdy, 2 votes. Adelaide, S. Goodwin, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Port Adelaide. Brisbane, D. Bradshaw, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, D. Brogan, 2 votes. Brisbane, L. Power, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Sydney. Collingwood, J. Anthony, 1 vote. Sydney, A. Goods, 2 votes. Collingwood, D. Beams, 3 votes. St. Kilda versus North Melbourne. North Melbourne, D. Petrie, 1 vote. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, 2 votes. North Melbourne, A. Swallow, 3 votes. Carlton versus Melbourne. Carlton, M. Murphy, 1 vote. Carlton, B. Favola, 2 votes. Carlton, C. Judd, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Geelong. Western Bulldogs, J. Harbrow, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, M. Boyd, 2 votes. Geelong, G. Ablett, 3 votes.
It was another bumpy week in footy as emotions boiled over on the field and off.
The Western Bulldogs in third spot.
The game's happiest player had reason to smile as the Dogs got the jump on the Pies. It was the Nick Show for St Kilda.
Wonderful by Revolt.
6 goals from Revolt, 39 possessions from Dal Santo, and the Saints were once again winners.
Good finish.
And after a 72-point win over the Blues, the Crows went into the finals on a high. Any higher, and their feathers would have got stuck in the roof.
Oh! Outside the mark to the century!
22. Port Adelaide versus North Melbourne. Port Adelaide, D. Cassisi, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, R. Gray, 2 votes. North Melbourne, J. Gibson, 3 votes. West Coast versus Richmond. West Coast, A. Embley, 1 vote. West Coast, M. Lacroix, 2 votes. West Coast, T. Swift, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Essendon. Hawthorn, S. Mitchell, 1 vote. Essendon, M. Hurley, 2 votes. Essendon, B. Stanton, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, B. Johnson, 1 vote. Collingwood, H. Shaw, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, B. Lake, 3 votes. Carlton versus Adelaide. Adelaide, C. Knights, 1 vote. Adelaide, A. McLeod, 2 votes. Adelaide, B. Vince, 3 votes. Sydney versus Brisbane. Sydney, A. Goods, 1 vote. Brisbane, M. Clark, 2 votes. Brisbane, S. Black, 3 votes. Melbourne versus St Kilda. St Kilda, Al Hayes, 1 vote. St Kilda, N. Revolt, 2 votes. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 3 votes. Geelong versus Fremantle. Geelong, G. Ablett, 1 vote. Geelong, D. Milburn, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Bartell, 3 votes. I declare the winner of the 2009 Brownlow Medal, Gary Ablett of the Geelong Football Club.
Gary makes his way forward to a standing ovation, I'll call upon the chairman of the AFL Commission, Mike Fitzpatrick, and the reigning Brownlow medalist, Adam Cooney, to come forward for the presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Ablett of Geelong, one of the game's premier midfielders, drafted under the father-son rule from Motawarri and the Geelong Falcons, debuted in 2002, played 167 games, All-Australian last 3 years as a midfielder, winner of the last three AFLPA MVP awards as nominated by his peers. Third in last year's Brownlow medal and finished fourth in 2007. Winner of the club's second Brownlow medal in 3 years after Jimmy Bartel in 2007. In 2007 was part of the club's first premiership since 1963. Son of Australian Football Hall of Fame member, Gary Ablett Sr. May I now ask Adam Cooney to present the 2009 Brownlow medal to Gary Ablett. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding. Charge your glasses. To celebrate the winner of the 2009 Brownlow Medal, Gary Ablett from Geelong.
Gary Ablett.
Well done. Better save that.
Thank you, Michael. And thank you very much to Adam Cooney. Would you put your hands together for Michael and Adam and thank them for their participation? Three years goes pretty quickly, doesn't it?
It does, mate. Yeah, it still feels so surreal. I'm shaking.
It's fantastic. I was watching you down there with Lauren. She hasn't got the smile off her face since when you got to 28 votes, and I don't know who looked happier, you or her.
I know. She's had to put up with a lot of my complaining over the years, and I think she's just stoked that I'll be going home happy tonight. So.
We're so glad you are going home happily tonight, because last year it seemed to me that it was like a real kick in the guts for you. Were you absolutely shattered by that?
Oh, not really. Look, Cooney deserved it. He had a fantastic season. And, he was obviously, the best player of the year and well-deserved his award for sure.
Who was more nervous tonight, you or Lauren?
I think we were both very nervous, so... I don't know what to say, mate. I'm still shaking a bit.
It's an amazing week, isn't it? You know, you've got a chance to win a Brownlow and a Norm Smith in the 1 week.
Yeah, look, I'm not thinking about the Norm Smith too much, mate. It's fantastic. We've got another shot at the premiership. The guys are very excited about having another crack, and we think we've got the team to do it, so we're looking forward to getting in on it on Saturday.
Well, your dad might be thinking about it because it's his 20th anniversary. Tonight of winning his, or this week of winning his Norm Smith, I would imagine at this very minute he'd be tickled pink.
He would be stoked for me. It's going to be fantastic that I can go home and say I've done something that he hasn't done. So I'm excited about that. But yeah.
You've had an incredibly stable group down there at Geelong in the last 3 years. I think a couple of weeks ago, 18 of the 22 played in the 2007 Premiership side. That must be so beneficial to each and every player.
It is for sure. I mean, they're a fantastic bunch of blokes down there. We're really close down there as a group, and as I said, we're really looking forward to having another shot at it this weekend, and hopefully we can bring home that Premiership Cup. It'd be fantastic.
We often see shots of Coach Bomber Thompson in the coach's box. He's a very laid-back man. He sit there eating salad sandwiches or drinking Coke. Does he ever actually fire up?
Yeah, he does behind the scenes.
Does he?
Definitely does, yep. No, but he's he's normally pretty calm, and I've copped a few sprays in my time, so most of the time he's pretty good, and he's switched on to what's going on, and he's a great coach, and yeah, he's a big part of the reason why we're having another shot at a premiership.
Just changing tack for a moment, Gary, a number of elite sportsmen like to meet other elite sportsmen. Tiger Woods is coming out here, of course, for the Masters. Would you like to meet him?
Oh, yeah, I guess that'd be good. I'm going to go along and...
Well, he probably wants to meet you.
I don't know about that, mate. I don't know about that. But, yeah, I'll go along and watch it. I enjoy my golf, I'll go along. But I don't think he'd be interested in meeting me.
What about this week? I mean, you're on an absolute high at the moment. Now you've got to settle down, get your mind back on the job. Can you actually enjoy the next few days before Saturday?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we're, the last 2 years we've gone in pretty relaxed, and, I'm sure I'll forget about it after tonight and get back and get into training and do what I would normally do on a week and normally prepare and get into the game on Saturday. So I don't think it'd be too hard. We've got another chance at a premiership, so.
Now, you've already slipped one into your father. Are there any other people you might like to thank? The microphone is yours.
I do. I've got heaps of people I'd like to thank. I'd like to start off by thanking my family. They've been fantastic. Just a great support throughout my whole life, not just my footy career. My beautiful girlfriend, Lauren. She's just been amazing. Always a very positive person, and when I'm down, always seems to find the right thing to say to make me smile. And also, love to thank my teammates. Without you guys, I wouldn't be up here accepting this medal. It's kind of yours as well, guys, and hopefully we can get a premiership this week. It'd be fantastic.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2009 Brownlow medalist, Gary Ablett.
We'll take a break. Be back with more here at Brown shortly.
Emotional scenes here at Crown Palladium. Gary Ablett is the Brownlow medalist for 2009. Been a pretty good time in recent times for the Brownlow medalist. This is the eighth time in the past 10 years that the winner has played in the grand final. Gary, of course, is doing that on Saturday. An 8-vote margin eventually, the biggest since 1998 when Robert Harvey was successful. Chris Judd finished with 22 votes in second place. Lenny Hayes did extremely well. He finished in third spot. Simon Black in fourth. Always polls well. Tonight was no exception. 19 votes for him. Along with his skipper, Jonathan Brown. A great night for Jonathan. Nick Del Santo and Adam Goods polled 17 votes apiece. And Joel Selwood polled 16 votes. Let's go down to the floor. Tom Harley is about to have a chat with our own Tim Watson. Tim?
Well, Tom, just reward, I guess, for what's been a brilliant three seasons from Gary Ablett.
Yeah, without a doubt. He's had huge expectations from everyone going into the past couple of counts, and he's won the PA Awards and the Coaches Awards, so just deserves for a fantastic team player.
And very difficult to stand out in a star-studded midfield like Geelong's too.
Yeah, I think so. And great to see Joel Selwood, pole well, and obviously Jimmy Bartel as well. So the boys are really rapping Gary, and he really deserves what he's achieved so far. And as he said, even as his acceptance, it's all about the weekend now for Gaz, which is fantastic.
Well, you're the skipper. You've got to get his feet back on the ground now.
He'll be okay. I'm sure the media will hand him tomorrow. But I guess playing in the weekend, you can always sort of use that as an excuse to get back into a normal routine.
Well, what's it been like for him? Because there's so much attention on him wherever he goes.
Well, he just never ceases to amaze me the way he handles it all. A really private, introverted guy. And, he just does it. Everything with aplomb, so I think he'll be fine, and expect Gaz to play a really pivotal role on Saturday.
And has this been the best season that you've seen him play?
Oh, it's hard to say. It's really hard to say. I think that, as you said, the past three have all been equally as good. This one will probably go down as his best just by virtue of the fact he's won a Brownlow, so he's had a fantastic year.
Well, it's a lovely distraction to have. You had it a few years ago when Jimmy Bartel won the Brownlow, then you went on to win the flag, so it didn't disrupt you that year.
No, I mean, and that speaks volumes of Jimmy as well, that the type of boys both of them are, that, you know, Jimmy went out and played really well on the weekend, and you know, Gary's feet won't touch the ground for probably the next 24 hours, but he'll hit the track on Wednesday and he'll be in fine form.
Tom, thanks for your time. Good luck at the weekend.
Cheers, Tim. Thanks very much.
Well, if you're wondering how your team's individuals fared, let's have a look at all boards now for each and every team in the AFL. Starting off with Adelaide, Bernie Vince has had an exciting year. He was their top vote getter with 13 votes ahead of Scott Thompson, who polled 11. The Brisbane Lions, well, Simon Black and Jonathan Brown had a ding-dong tussle, didn't they? Both finishing up with 19 votes. Carlton, Chris Judd led the way with 22, but Bryce Gibbs and Mark Murphy have certainly stamped themselves as future stars. Collingwood, Scott Pendlebury polled 13, Alan Didak and Dane Swan polled the even dozen. They were the top three vote getters there. Job Watson did well for the Bombers with Jason Winderlich, each scoring 10 votes, while Matthew Pavlich and Aaron Sandlands did exactly likewise at Fremantle. Gary Ablett, there is the story of the night from Geelong, scoring 30 votes, 16 for Joel Selwood. Jimmy Bartel picked up 13, as did the happy chappy Paul Chapman. Brad Sewell polled 13 votes, Sam Mitchell did, but he was ineligible. Luke Hodge polled 7. Brent Harvey for the Kangaroos was their leading vote getter. He picked up 9 votes. Aaron Davey, the leading vote getter at Melbourne, with 6 ahead of Brent Maloney. And as far as Port Adelaide is concerned, David Roden polled 7, so did Warren Treadray. Matthew Richardson, Richo, picked up 6. Ben Cousins and Brett Deledio and Daniel Jackson all polled 5 votes. For St Kilda, well, look at this. The top 5 polled a staggering 79 votes, led by Lenny Hayes, who polled 20 votes. Adam Goods led the way for the Sydney Swans, as he has done in the past, ahead of Brett Kirk and best and fairest winner Ryan O'Keefe, both of those with 11. Mark Lacroix, he's an exciting young forward, picked up 9 votes this year ahead of Matt Prittis. Matthew Boyd was the leading Bulldog with 14 votes ahead of another rising star in Sean Higgins, who polled 11 votes. So that will bring you up to date with each and every team. As some ponder their future, some wonder about tonight, some think about the weekend. But Gary Ablett, what a night, what a win. And if you think the footy is just about finished on 7, you're mistaken. Have a look at this. This Wednesday night, game day goes prime.
On Friday Night Football.
Go, Jones, how are you, mate?
Oh, big brother, but also our best mate.
Put your boots back on.
I love you.
Success without the ultimate success.
Football's an amazing game.
Oh, good morning.
Enjoy it. Get out there and get into it.
Yeah, there was something put on the table, but.
Well, thanks, Murphy. It's possible in this moment.
It's cool. We're ready to go around again.
It's a special moment.
I didn't study first.
I'm not an ego coach, put it that way.
Keep pushing the ball forward.
Great to have Rob on, his twin brother, on the show.
That's not his assessment.
other people.
You know what? The other people don't get the shot.
I'm sure you've just been given a free Mercedes.
Yeah, I have, and Lee actually is dating one of the girls at work.
Welcome back. I've been joined by Dennis once again. In fact, I think we're the only two who are actually focusing at the moment in this room because they've very quickly gone into relaxed mode. But on a serious note, Dennis, 3 years he's waited for this particular night. I think well worth the wait.
When you think back to 2007, he was sitting alongside Jimmy Bartel. That had to be tough. It wasn't his design. I mean, he didn't set up the room, but there he was alongside Bartel. Bartel wins last year. Last card of the night, he loses. So normally, we don't get too emotionally involved in who wins, but tonight, I think I'm very happy he did.
Yeah, I agree. He's got to look ahead to Saturday afternoon. We also look ahead to that. What are your thoughts? Geelong and St Kilda, no doubt the best two sides right throughout the season.
Yeah, terrific in round 14 when you think back. That was a classical game. I jumped on and off the Geelong bus. I got off a few weeks ago
Where
and
are
said,
you at the moment? Lara?
Sidey? Doing a side bottom. I think I'm back on. Yeah,
are you?
I think I'm back on.
Is that because of the second half of Saturday night?
I'm easily swayed. But I came out and said I don't think they can win. And then the following week, they can't win. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I think they will win.
So perhaps we might tune into the game day special on Wednesday night to see if Dennis has, in fact, changed his mind once again.
I will have.
Just on a serious note,
we
know that Bruce sadly can't be with us tonight due to a passing in the family. But our thoughts, Bruce, are certainly with you and your family.
Doesn't seem like finals time without him.
No.
And certainly Friday night, there was a vacant chair alongside. So we'd like him to hurry back, but of course he's got to take his time, and a very sad time for the family.
Indeed it is, but come back soon, Brucey, and all the best. We look ahead to the weekend, and of course we've got a game day special on Wednesday night. Lots happening as far as the build-up to the grand final is concerned, so I hope you can stay with us on 7. I hope you've enjoyed tonight. We certainly have, Dennis.
Can I just say, Sandy, fantastic job. Short notice. You were remarkable.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I hope you at home have enjoyed it. And for now, on behalf of the entire 7 team, it's good night from the Palladium and congratulations to our winner, Gary Ablett.
Good night.
He's in trouble.
He doesn't. He's
gone. He takes a screamer.
Jimmy Steins. That's a contested mark, too.
Has kicked a goal from the pocket.
A nasty collision.
Put on your Superman cakes, boy. It's Wharfie time. Let's go. Hit the half. You pitcher. Trent Ray.
Johnson comes in. Oh, he's missed.
Oh, big play from Rundy. He's been the king of the air tonight.
He plays on to improve the angle. He's kicked at the score.
He has just been outstanding the whole time.
Fist is an opening
in the face.
Yes.
Go.
Shoot.
Runs to 45. And he dribbles one through.
Jim Steins, number 37 jumper. For Vola's
there. Oh, no way.
Parker to bounce it around the corner. Oh, Leon Davis.
Jimmy Bartel to make a hero of himself. He's kicked a point. The best point he'll ever kick.
The famous flick pass.
Beautiful. He's been a great footballer for a long time.
He's kicking it for the Tigers. It's long! It's long! He's marked it! And Lee will get it
through! After 300 games, Mickey O'Loughlin.
He's in the top 1% of all time's games. Record. To win the game for the Saints, he's missed! Rewald has missed!
Oh! By Lloyd
Burton! Oh! That's one of the marks of the century!
I heard it described once, when you leave the field for the last time, part of you dies, so it's a sad time.
You can see how much it means to him. It's so emotional.
Screws the ball around.